Hello, everyone. It's the Dread Pirate once again, and I'm gonna get off my ass and do something today. We're gonna play some D&D, and with me is Alex. Alex, what's up?
Hello, Pavo.
Alex, last we met, your cyborg ninja was eaten by lions.
And you did not have fun.
It was very sad because not only you were a cyborg ninja, but you were also a vampire Fremen, which is metal. And then you immediately got eaten by lions. So I'm upset about that. But what's your new character?
I am Venom this time.
You are Venom. Like arch nemesis of another character, a Spider-Man.
Oh yes.
Who may be in this game, especially since I did a recap talking about how I was playing Spider-Man.
Oh yes.
Yes, excellent. And so we're gonna do a brief recap of how you got here. First of all, you're Eddie Brock. You've got the symbiote again. Due to a bizarre series of events, you're a heroic version of Venom. You're trying to be a hero again. The symbiote still hates Spider-Man, and you've also got Flash Thompson running around in your brain. And you recently discovered that you have a son. And then you begin frolicking through New York City screaming, "I have a son!" And grabbing Spider-Man, "Spider-Man, I have a son!" And hugging him and then trying to bite him. And then you went up to Wolverine and punched him and it's like, "Wolverine, I have a son!" And then you ran into Darth Vader and Vader's like, "You have a son? Yes, I have a son! I have a son!" And you started skipping through the... Because you had a son! You had a son!
Yay!
Yes, that's canon now, because I'm a dick. This is all true. What happened was a bunch of the heroes went into space chasing down a bunch of villains, and one of them was Spider-Man, and you saw that, and you know, you thought to yourself, "I should go check on Peter, make sure he's okay." And then Flash Thompson said, "Yeah, you should go check on Peter, make sure he's okay." And then the symbiote said, "Yeah, we should go find Peter, and I could rip out his spleen." And so for a myriad of reasons, you decided to follow Spider-Man to this alien planet, and you, much like him, you crash-landed on this planet because you are not a pilot, and you had to steal a sword ship in order to get here, sword being the intergalactic counterbalance shield, and you've been stuck here for about a month. You managed to track Peter down Dagger Falls, the city of Randall Moore. And you found out from the townspeople that Spider-Man is like been defending the city, and he went to the Droidian crypts in order to investigate some drow that were attacking the place. And he went there with a couple of weird looking people, like a cyborg ninja and a man with a high tech piece of armor and a German accent and some hippy dippy robot truck car person. And you're here where the little square is. And you're at the Droidian crypts, and there's a mausoleum to your left and another mausoleum to your right and the crypt in front of you. What are you going to do?
Go straight ahead.
Sure, you don't want to go to the right? I think you want to go to the right.
I'm not doing that again.
You want to go to the right and get horribly bitten, of course, obviously.
No.
Okay, you are...
No, we're not.
Okay, you are in D3. There's a hallway. There's a bunch of dead bodies that smell really bad in front of you. And again, you're new to this world. All you know about this world is that humans are here, or what you think are humans. For all you know, they're pink Kree. And there's also elves and dwarves and dragons and goblins and magic and fantasy. It's magical. It's a big magical fart, and it's beautiful. But you're used to this, you know, being a Marvel character. But you don't really have much in you know that there's such a thing known as the dark elves that occasionally fuck with Thor. But you don't typically, that's not typically something you have to deal with on a regular basis. So you're really kind of not used to seeing this, but it's like, as far as you know, these are dark elves and they're decaying in front of you, in front of D4. What are you going to do? Sorry. Checking all my monitors. What was that, sir?
Gonna move on.
To where?
Brain move on.
To where? You're gonna go to D4, you're gonna go to D5, you're gonna go in the hallway, you're gonna go to D6. Are you gonna eat these delicious like drow corpses in front of you? They're nice and rotten.
But absolutely, awesome. Help me.
You're breaking up again. Okay. What do you need? What do you need help with?
I was pacifying your people. I was alone here.
Okay.
I couldn't hear you.
Okay. Well, thank you, sir. Where are you going to go? Are you going to go to D? You said you're going to go to D4. You're going to go to D5. You're going to go to the hallway. You're going to go D6. Where exactly are you going to go?
Hallway.
Okay, the hallway. Okay, you round the corner and you see a what appears to be a dead body, with its legs like coming out of the doorway and lying face down. It appears to have some kind of nasty neck injury and a couple tears to its side. It's bleeding out at the neck. It appears to be humanoid, wearing some kind of high-tech armor. Looks kind of like a ninja. Had a sword in his hand, and it looks like something badly molded.
I'm thinking.
Okay.
Let's just...
Yes.
I'm trying to think of, like, what if I eat you?
You're going to eat Genji's corpse.
I'm just wondering, because, like, could I just eat his medicine?
You went really robo just now. Say it again.
I just ate his medicine?
You're really... I can't hear you, man. Are you close to the mic?
Yeah. Okay. Sorry. Could I just gain his memories and stuff like that?
Do you have that power?
I have no idea. Hang on.
I don't think I gave you an ability to do that. As far as I know, you do not have the ability to eat people's brains and steal their knowledge. Mm. Although that's an awesome idea for power. Are you there, sir?
Yes, I'm here.
Okay.
Sorry. I'm just looking.
I'm paranoid with my connection troubles.
Makes sense.
Are you going to eat Genji?
I'm trying to see if I could eat him and get Genji's memories of like where the trap is.
Oh, okay. Are you actually gonna do that?
Sure, I guess.
Okay, you're gonna eat. I love you, Alex. I love you so much. I love all the stupid things you choose to do. Okay, you're gonna eat Genji. How are you gonna start eating Genji?
Okay, his just start with the leg, I guess.
Okay, what are you gonna do with the leg?
I'm gonna. Tongue and cut it into pieces.
You're gonna tongue the leg and cut it into pieces.
Yes, we're tonguing the leg.
Okay, so you get down on your hands. This is happening right now.
Yes.
You get down on hands. You get down on your hands and knees, and you start tonguing the leg, and you start biting it.
I'm Eddie. Oh Lord, hang on. Did I change it to the Venom symbiote before I do this?
I assumed you already were in your symbiote suit, but go ahead.
Yeah, yes, let's do that.
Okay, so you get down on your hands and knees, you start tonguing the leg, and you start biting the leg into pieces.
Okay. This might take a while, but this might be also, this also might be quick. I don't know.
Oh, yeah, sure. I'm going to let you do something dumb like this and let it be quick. Sure. Of course I am. Okay. I'm going to check what Genji's damage reduction was real quick. If I can find it. Where did I put that box? Okay. Yeah, just do, you have a bite attack, right? Alex, are you there? Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, do you have a bite attack, right?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, just like, do your bite damage to the body.
Give me a moment. I gotta pull up the random thing, because, I'm so...
Actually, okay, before you even do that, just make a sleight of hand or a dexterity check real quick.
Okay, I'm gonna pull up that random number generator or something.
Okay.
No, I'll just type in a random number generator. I'm not ready for this.
But neither am I. An 18. I mean, it doesn't look like you have damage reduction, so...
Okay, is it like 1d10, or how are we doing this?
You don't have to... Just tell me what your damage is, like, and just roll your damage, basically. For your bite attack. It's a dead body. It's a dead body. You can't really miss it. So,
hang on. Okay. Plus 53.
What, for your dexterity?
Hang on. Oh, flip. No, dexterity is 18. Plus 4.
Okay, well, I'm not sure you have sleight of hand as a skill. You probably do as a rogue. But let me see. Okay. Oh, you plus 53 for your bite. I'm looking for your damage. Okay, you deal 9 damage. You deal 9 damage with a bite attack, basically. Okay. You don't have any damage reduction that I can see. Yeah, do a... Trying to see. Yeah, this right here. Sleight of hand. Do a sleight of hand check real quick. Plus 4. So roll d20 and add 4 to it.
Yeah. That's all I need to know.
All right, what'd you get?
8.
What's that? You got an 8?
D4.
Say it one more time.
D4.
D4?
I rolled a 20, and then I added 4 to it.
Oh, 24. Okay, alright. Alright, you're fine. Okay. So, your tongue wraps around the leg, and, The leg is kind of hard because it's armored, but you don't really, you know, with a little bit of chewing, you're able to bite into the leg, and you start eating his leg and start slowly moving the body back to you like you're a fucking Pac-Man. And you start eating his leg. Are you going to eat the whole Genji?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, we're eating the whole Genji.
Okay, well... So, you're eating Genji, starting with the legs, and you get about halfway up the second leg, and you were completely full. You notice that, it whatever this is, it tastes a little bit like tuna or chicken. And it's a little buttery, and it's just got dark. But yeah, like, you get halfway up the leg, and you're now unbelievably full, having eaten the leg. You have not absorbed any memories as of yet. But you desecrated the corpse and committed cannibalism, so good job.
Whatever.
I thought you were supposed to be the good Venom.
Sure! I'm prone to, like, acts of cannibalism every now and then.
Sure you are. Okay. You feel full, and make a fortitude save.
Is that again? I forget everything.
Oh my god. Such a new...
Yeah.
You're gonna... Plus 10. Roll d20 plus 10.
Okay.
What do you got?
So, 28.
28? Okay. You got a little bit of the itis. But other than that, you're fine. You're not fatigued. But you're full. You don't feel like you biologically do not feel like eating more Genji. Do you just keep eating? Are you going to gorge yourself?
No.
Okay. All right. What are you going to do? The body is now here with you in this, like, in this part of the hallway. You pulled him into the hallway, so you're good. Say it again.
Just at, like, D5, then.
You're going to go into D5?
Oh.
You're going to go into D5.
We're not going into D5.
You sure? You just said, yes. Sound like to me, you said you wanted to walk into D5. Let's walk into D5.
No, damn it. No.
Okay. Are you going to go
into
D5?
We're not going there.
No, you're not going into D5. Okay. All right.
Not going into D5.
You're not going into D5. Okay. Okay. You're definitely good. Going into D5. Okay, so a bunch of lions eat. No. Okay.
Oh,
what
no.
What are you going to do?
We're going to jump down. We're going to, when I say jump, I mean like we're going to move. We're going to move down to D17?
Yeah. Okay. All right. Okay, so you move your way down, you pass by the. A sealed crypt. You basically find that you wind up in the catacombs. You see the scary looking alien like freaking statue right here. Start making your way through the catacombs and basically you get all the way to here, get to the tunnel, make your way to the tunnel, and yeah, there is a what looks used to be a wall here that's been broken into and a hole in the ground. So what are you gonna do?
Oh.
You're gonna go down the hole?
Yes, we're going down the hole.
You're going down the hole, okay.
We are going down the hole.
We are going down the hole. You go down the hole, welcome to the new map. So you go through a tunnel, and
sending it to my phone real quick.
I could send it to you over Discord.
I just do that. That's
fine. But, I mean... Hold on.
But just do it.
Well, hang on a fucking minute. I'm not, like, it's not easy for me to do that. But when I get, okay. Take a snapshot. There we go. All right. There you go. All right. Do I need to keep screen share up?
Nah.
Okay. All right. I'm gonna take screen. Yeah, just to ease. We're less likely to have like you know getting cut out if I take screen share off. So. Okay. All right. So you come down through this tunnel and you see S1. See a little table over here. Let me read the description. Okay. If I can find it. Meridian Crypts D. Okay. with more cane features. It's gonna be doing that to me the rest of the damn game though. S1 entry pod. Well, you don't see any of this because all right, okay, you don't really see anything because the only thing that really is pertinent to you since we did all this before with the rest of the party was the cavern is comfortably appointed with four padded wooden chairs set around a square table. So yeah, you see like it's a cave, but there's like there's a chair with several wooden tables, and it looks like there's this place has been basically kind of retrofuted into like some kind of like office, and that's where you're at basically. So and you don't make a spot check.
What is that again?
Hang on. Well, hang on a second because I gotta do something myself here. My spider sense doesn't work on you, so. So I only have a plus nine. If you could find spot, should be on your character sheet. Let's go down until you find it. I'll help in a minute when I can. So.
Okay. I'm looking.
Okay. All right. I have a 15.
Plus three.
Plus three? Okay. Did you roll a d20?
No.
Okay.
13.
Okay. All right. You don't see anything. What are you gonna do?
Examine the table.
You're gonna examine the table?
Yeah.
Okay. How are you gonna examine the table?
So, I think.
What?
Like, just look at it and like. If I can't find anything,
It looks like it's been damaged a little bit. It looks like there was some food and playing cards that were on it that were kind of scattered. A couple of the chairs look like they've been knocked over. Looks like a weapon was hit with it at some point, like something sharp was chopped into it at one point. But other than that, it looks like it's been recently used. But that's all you notice.
Okay, I guess I'm moving on then.
Okay, so where do you go?
S3.
You're gonna go to S3? Okay. All right, so you start, like, you're still in the hole. You're, like, you've only popped your head out. Are you going to crawl, like, what are you, how are you going to get to S3?
Crawl?
Are you going to crawl on the ceiling? Okay. So you start crawling on the ceiling, and then right when you get about here, you suddenly hear a whispering behind you and says, Brock, shh, don't make any noise. And please, please, for the love of God, don't kill me. The voice sounds familiar. The symbiote begins to bristle with anger.
Oh, boy.
Shh. We're being watched.
Who?
The dark elves. Some shit went down here. If you look behind you, you stand on the ceiling... Like, holding onto the ceiling itself and, like, trying to be quiet behind you is Spider-Man, the man you came to find. He very, very cautiously, because, you know, it's you, and he finds you very scary, he moves up to your side and says, like, I came here, I found a couple other people that were stuck here. I found, they're not from this planet. I got separated from Cap and the other Avengers, but like, there's a couple other people that were stuck here. There was one of the, you remember the Transformers?
Yes.
Yeah, one of them, Beachcomber, was here. So I found him, there are these two other guys, you're never going to believe this. It was like these, they're video game characters. It's like, I don't know, Brock, we haven't talked too much. I don't know if you play video games at all. Probably not. Reinhardt and Genji from Overwatch. You have no idea what I'm talking about, do you? Okay, never mind. Anyway, they're clearly from another dimension, and they're stuck here. And I was trying to help them get home, and we all agreed to go for the king and go and, you know, investigate this place. Basically, a bunch of the Dark Elves have been, like, raiding the surface, and so we were trying to get to the bottom of it. And that crypt was full of freaking monsters and all sorts of nasties. And apparently there's some kind of civil war going on down here. Like, there's... You know, apparently, like, their goddess has fallen silent, and a lot of the drow think that they're being abandoned, and this other crazy cult has taken over, and they're, like, they've been doing horrible things to the old believers of the old faith. They've been, like, skinning them alive and shit, and they turn them into these, like, horrible skinless monsters. I had to fight one. It was really freaky. We were about to interrogate them and take them back when a bunch of reinforcements showed up from beyond. See this web over here? Like, from this spot here, like, there's apparently a barracks. A bunch of them came up and attacked us, and one of them was, like, a wizard. And he used some kind of spell and grabbed, like, Beachcomber and Reinhardt and then, like, teleported them away. We lost track of Genji. I don't know what happened to him. I think he's still back in the town. But, yeah, so I was able to hide. I was, like, you know, I basically just kind of was able to hide in this crevice and basically just kind of moved around here for a little bit. But I've been down here this entire time. I've been trying to find a way to go rescue. We have to go rescue these guys, like, figure out what these elves are up to, and then find a way to get the hell off this planet. You didn't happen to show up with, like, the Fantastic Four or anything like that, with, like, a spaceship to get me out of here by any chance, did you?
No.
Or are you here to kill me?
Came to check on you, actually.
Okay. I appreciate that. I do. So, What do you think we should do?
Your friends. Lead me to the people you found.
Yeah, they got, like... So the wizard grabbed them with some kind of telekinesis and then dragged them, like, this way. Like, all the way to the other side of the webbing. And they started shooting at me, I had to fight them, and I had to, like... You know, I basically just kind of, like, crawled the walls and got out of their reach. I got lost down here for a little bit, and I finally made my way back here, and I've been trying to avoid their patrols. I think they're a little short-staffed. Like, this area we're in right now, it used to be a guard post for them. But after the drow that we took out, like, we killed some of them, and we hospitalized some other ones. They haven't restocked this place, so it's like, I guess they're just kind of keeping an eye out on the place from the barracks. But, yeah. So, I don't know, we'd have to... I think they're somewhere down here, but we'd have to explore further in order to figure out exactly what happened.
Okay. Let's just...
Okay.
Then we will find them.
Okay, all right. You lead the way, man. I'm exhausted. I'd like someone else to take charge for a minute.
Okay. Ooh, I'm on S3 right now, right?
He stopped you. You're still in S1. You have not made it to S3 yet.
Yeah.
Okay, but are you still going to S3?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so before you get to S3, there's this big chasm and in front of you, and then there's another wall across. And... I think there's, like, if you were not spider people with fantastic powers that could do whatever a spider can, there would be there's a short, like, small, like, you know, kind of edge pathway that you could cling to if you absolutely needed to, but you could stick to walls. But there is this massive chasm in front of you, and S3 is in this little hole on the side here. So, while you're... You think about a way to get over there. I'm going to go read the description for S2 real quick. Okay. The chasm. In striking contrast to the deathly still air elsewhere in the caverns, a cold, strong breeze blows up from some unknown depth here. A chasm yawns in the earth, reaching far down to the endless reaches of the Underdark. Though it is only about 30 feet wide, the rift continues for hundreds of feet on either side. Large webs stretch down into the darkness, and from far below, you can hear rushing water. So, how are you going to get across the chasm?
The walls!
With what?
The walls with my webs.
You're gonna web to the wall?
Yes.
Okay. You do it automatically because you're fucking Venom, and I'm not gonna make you do a skill check for that. Alright. I'm gonna look at your version of the web of the map here for my own sanity. Okay, so you're on the wall on the other way across. I assume you're gonna climb your way to S3, right?
Yes.
Okay, you climb your way to S3, and I'm going to read the description. And I took a picture for no good reason. Okay. Clean and dry, the small cavern feels more like a roadside campsite than an underground cave. Halfway into the cavern, the floor drops away in a short but steep cliff, leading to a lower area about 10 feet down. A bedroll, tightly rolled and neatly tied, and a backpack line the lower section, propped against the north wall. Otherwise, the room seems clear. You should make a spot check.
Yeah. So 9.
You got a 9?
Yes.
That's not high enough, but fortunately you have a Spider-Man with you. So, and he has, and he, his powers may not work on you, but they work on other things, so. I sense danger. and specifically I use the sight. There's someone in here. And he starts pointing into the darkness, and you follow his hand, and you realize that there is someone hiding in the darkness, kind of leaning against a rock on the wall, and appears to be sharpening a rapier of some kind. It's a woman. She has dark skin, and with pointed ears and silver hair. She looks very similar to the drow you saw above ground. However, she also has apparently some darker hair, coarse hair, kind of starting to grow outside of her the sides of her arms and her back. Part of her body appears to be hardening into some kind of carapace, and it appears like she has an extra set of arms. That's like there's a kind of like almost like she's a spider herself. Closer examination, she has bright, golden, intense eyes. And looks like somewhat spider-like mandibles. She's basically seems more spider than elf. She looks like she'd actually be very attractive if she wasn't a spider person. She has noticed you, and she's looking at you very, very carefully as she's basically kind of sharpening her blade. But she's just kind of staying cool and staying in the shadows, hoping you haven't noticed her. Although it's apparent that, yeah, you do see her. But she's just standing there kind of looking at you. She also appears to have some kind of there's some kind of black mark on her neck. You can't really see it too well from this distance. It's like a black mark with some kind of pattern. And Spider-Man's like, I think this one's occupied. She definitely set off my spider sense. I can attest to that.
I'm gonna ask who she is.
She looks at you. She looks at you and freezes and does not respond.
This whole reassuring thing, so I'm gonna let Spider-Man take care of that.
You're like, what do you want me to do?
reassure her that we're not gonna kill her.
Yeah, sure. I'll do that.
You're better at that than I am.
No, I'm not.
You are.
Go, Brock. Use your winning personality. Go.
Sell yourself short.
Hi. Could you? She shifts to the two of you. Do you want to send all of the guards upon us and have us all be killed? No. Then keep your voice down. This is my cave. Find your own. Look. Starts clawing on the walls and carefully steps down. We're not looking to stay. We just kind of want to talk. Talk about what? Have you? Spit it out. Whatever you are. Clearly, the two of you are spiderkin. We are spider people. I'm actually Spider-Man. This is my friend Venom. And, but we're not from around here, per se. Yeah. Whatever you are, it's not unusual. Many creatures down here have been touched by the goddess Loth. Myself included. She begins stepping out of the shadows, and you notice that the mark on her is... She has what appears to be, some kind of jewel on her neck, and it's a scarab, and it appears to be actually kind of be it appears to be jewelry, but it's actually like stuck in her neck, growing out of her neck, and not growing out of her neck, but it's right underneath where her esophagus, right on top of where her esophagus would, or like no, right above like her rib cage, like her the center of the rib cage, there's this scarab artifact, and it's embedded in her skin and clearly cannot be removed. And now you notice. And I am a fang of Loth. I've been touched by the goddess herself. I am one of the last of her that are still faithful. Last of hers that are still faithful. The filth of the White Lady has taken over. They have killed my sisters. And now I hide here in this cave. I was pushed out of Maramidra. Are you perhaps part of the cult of Caransali as well? Are you really their scouts here to kill me? Blah, 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 what?
It was kind of... It's breaking up again.
What was the last thing you heard me say?
Asked us whether we were something.
Are you members of the cult? Are you members of the cult of Caransali? It's here to kill me. Perhaps a scouting party. If you are, I assure you, you won't live long enough to tell anyone I'm here.
Oh, we are not. Simply here. Look for my partner's friends.
Your friends? Yeah, I'm actually from the surface. A spiderkin from the surface world. That's a laugh. It's a really long, crazy story. But, I'm looking for, there's a man in a big suit of armor. Looks kind of like a knight. But, there's, jets that shoot out of his back. Like, big jets of fire, and he can move really, really fast. And there's another person who's very, very big. It's like a construct, like a golem. And he can sometimes turn into like a four-wheeled like vehicle, and he's really, really into nature. Oh, I remember you. Yes, I watched your little scuffle from over here. You put on quite a show and then ran for it. Yes. Very well. Clearly you're not one of the White Lady's minions. I know not where your allies are, but they've clearly been taken by the cult of Caransali. They're probably dead by now. We drow have little need for you surface dwellers, and the cult of Caransali is uncivilized by our standards. If you wish to possibly rescue your comrades, you'll have to go up against them. They are the power down here in Sith Morcaine, as is much of the Underdark.
That's what we'll do.
You mean it?
Yes.
You mean to kill these followers of the White Lady?
Oh. It's silent again.
I'm waiting for you. Can you hear me?
Yeah, we're good.
Okay. What's the last thing you hear me? Do you hear me say the last line?
Yes.
Okay. You mean to kill the White Lady?
Yes. If it comes down to it.
I don't do the killing thing. But I'm definitely willing to fight them, and if they've taken over the place, they're causing problems on the surface. We'll gladly help you get rid of them. They've been killing and skinning my sisters alive, turning them to abominations.
Killing them, Spider-Man. We're killing them.
You two can kill them, I'll knock them out. Look, I'll help you fight them. That's what I'll do. But,
Fine. Fine.
Your surface morals make no sense to me. If you wish to... If you will oppose the White Lady and the cult of Kurensali, you will have my sword. But I assure you, I will give them their kind no quarter.
Good. As he has morals, unfortunately.
He will not live long down here in the Underdark. But before the demons of the pit consume him, you have told me your name, I will tell you mine. I am Lorala Dumian, Fang of Loth. Last loyal sister left alive. Congratulations, Laura Dumian has joined your party.
Okay!
Yay! Yeah. And the last time I ran this game, she became a major character. And my character, hooked up with her, so. It was a whole thing. It's why get the princess when I can get a disgusting Spider Woman? So, all right, I guess I have to keep her character.
Good luck. Yeah.
I have to keep her character sheet nearby.
You know the robot thing.
Blah, robot. Can you hear me? Alex, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, Laurel Dumian has joined your party. What are you guys gonna do?
Hold on.
Just to clarify, this is where you came in, which is shown here. Chasm is here, and this is basically the spot that you're in here is way over here, off the map. So.
Wait, S3 then?
It's more it's over here, and it's just we can't see it. So if you were to come out here and look up, you'd see this massive web that leads to all these little cave entrances. And that's what all the entrances are. That's what it looks like.
Okay. Let's go for S12.
You go to S12. Okay. How are you going to approach S12? So, I'm going to screen share real quick. Still hear me?
Yep.
Okay. All right. So again, I don't know if I made that clear, but it's okay. So you're in here. Well, you're in here. This is where you came in, and you came out, went to the chasm, and you crawled on the wall, went into this little outcropping. So basically, you're in a wall right here. So if you were to come out and look up, you see the big web. So you're down here somewhere. How are you going to get from there to S12?
Ah, okay. Web swing?
Okay. You're gonna web swing just up here. As you start climbing higher, you start approaching the web. What are you gonna do when you once you get to the web?
I'll just make a beeline for S12 then.
Okay, there's the webbing in your way.
Mm.
Like this right here is on top of the web. You're underneath the web.
Okay, so I'll have to cut through the web then. Maybe I can bite it.
All right, you go to the web and you bite it?
Yeah.
Okay, you've bitten the webbing and you are now stuck. Your mouth is now stuck on the webbing itself.
What?
Yeah, hold on, let me, now bad things
will happen. Does that
work? Bad things will happen. Stop taking pictures. Okay. Let me, oh my god, stop. Okay. Ah. Yeah, you've bitten it. You have -2 to attack rolls, -4 to your dexterity. You can't cast spells, but you can't cast spells anyway. And upon biting the web, you suddenly hear the web shake. As if something massive is now moving on the web. You need to roll initiative.
What is initiative again? My brain...
Well, it's on your character sheet, like towards the top.
Again.
You found it?
On the robot again.
Can you hear me now? Alex, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
What's this initiative thing again? My brain went.
Go to the top of your character sheet. And it's right there underneath your AC. You have a +4. What?
A +4.
Yeah. Roll a d20.
Sixteen
total?
+20. Well, +4. Four.
You have 20 total.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. All right, you have a 20. And it's going to be a little difficult because I don't have easy access to Lara's character sheet. I got to go in the back for her, but whatever. I think all of them are in the same spot, basically. Okay, she's around here somewhere. Oh, my God. She's a +8. Lorala crits.
Was that a natural crit or?
Yeah, she crit. She hit a 20.
Oh, okay.
And. Where's the big guy? Ooh. There it is. Fortunately, he's dumb. He's got a 6. Okay.
Look to me.
Okay. So Lorala basically follows you by just, you're not sure how exactly she got there. She just flies up to you. Closer examination, you notice she has little wings on her boots. She flies up to you and looks at you like, you idiot, you've woken it up now. And she pulls out her sword and she cuts the webbing free, so your mouth is still, like, stuck closed, but you can move away from the webbing now. So you're free. You have to do a move action in order to get the gunk out of your mouth, though. It is your turn. Alex, can you hear me? Okay, it's your turn. What are you going to do?
Can I just pull out that webbing now?
You pull out the webbing. Yeah. Is that all you're going to do?
Yes.
Okay. All right. Yeah. And, Ahmed's online, too, by the way.
Really?
Yeah, you want me to invite him to the call?
Bring him in here. Yeah, it's been a while.
Okay. Let's see. Add friends to DM.
Bring him in here.
Okay. See if he answers. Dude, you there? Ahmed. Hello? Okay, that didn't work. And I've lost my connection. Shit. God damn it. Why do I have such a shitty connection? Bear with me, folks. I have a shitty connection, as usual. Hey.
Yes, hello.
Dog with two bones, man. Dog with two bones.
Yeah.
All right, so, yeah, we tried to get a hold of him. I think he got cut off, and that, like, caused, like, my connection to completely be destroyed. So whatever. Yeah, it was a nice attempt. I was hoping to get Reinhardt in here.
He tried.
All right, you get the gunk out of your mouth. Is that all you're gonna do? That's probably all you can do. Yeah.
That's probably all I can do.
Yeah. Spider-Man catches up to you on a web line, and then clings to the wall and is going to climb under, like, through a hole on underneath the web, so he's on top of it. So he's basically higher up than where you're at. So he kind of looks around to see what's going on, and basically, if you're looking at the map over from the left-hand side, a giant spider starts making its way across the web and is basically making its way towards your position.
Nope. I guess we're just gonna, like, go through the same hole he went through, like Spider-Man went through, and
yeah, fix okay,
that. Yeah.
All right. Basically, now the creature It runs out from the left and is basically standing right on top. It's basically in a place where it can attack Spider-Man if it wants to, because he's on the wall high up above you, so it's like looking right at him, and Spider-Man's like, eep, and you're right underneath it. So that's where you're at. So Lorala, against her better judgment, flies up next to Spider-Man, and you climb up next to it. I guess Spider-Man's go. Yeah! Giant, it's like the Battle of Ultimate Spiders. What am I going to do? Oh, I'm not at full health, too. Great. So, giant spider, bad day. Let's see. I am going to shoot it with my web shooters. I'm going to entangle it. So I have a plus 17. It's 27. Let me check its AC. 18. I hit it. Okay, so Spider-Man's just like, gulp. He shoots a web lining at the thing, webs up its face and starts webbing its body, and it just kind of falls on its side, shaking the entire web. And it appears to be stuck for the time being. And I'm trying to remember what its options are. It's its turn, and it's trapped, so it's going to have to pick something. It could either damage the webbing, which is at 12 hit points. It could break it at a 22 DC, or escape it at a 22. It's got a 23 strength, so the break DC is probably the best option. So it has a plus 6 to break out of it. So that's what it's gonna try to do. 19. It tries to break the webbing and is not succeeding in breaking the webbing. It's stuck. All right, and Lorala. Okay. Trying to remember what Lorala has. Lorala's got that nice keen scimitar. Lorala, seeing that the creature's vulnerable, draws her rapier and charges, flying at it. Yeah! And she comes and chops it. And she's going to chop it twice, and she's going to bite it. So she's plus 11, plus 6, and plus 5.
Okay.
So 20 hits. 15 misses. And a 9 misses. So she chops it once with her scimitar and damages it.
She chops once and misses twice then?
Yes.
Gotcha.
She hit it once. Okay. 1d6 plus 2. Man, I missed my dice. She deals 3 damage to it. So she chops it with its back and pisses it off. Howls, pissed off, and it's like, whoa, I'm gonna, why I oughta, when I get out of this thing, I'm gonna bite you. Ooh. So. Okay. And, alright, so she's pissed it off. It's your turn.
Good. I'm going to web bullet it.
You're going to web bullet it?
Yeah.
All right, make your attack.
We're going to do... It's 31, 26, 21, so that's like... I'm going to... Perform it.
I do believe you're the highest level person here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
8, dice 6. Oh. So that's...
You may not have absorbed his knowledge, but you might have absorbed Genji's power. The spice must flow into your stomach.
Question. 8 dice 6. Yes. Right now. It's been a while. 8 dice 6. What is that?
We're looking at your web bullets.
Yes.
It's been a long time since I worked on this sheet.
Wait, no, that's a sneak. Wait, 14 damage plus a sneak attack. Okay, hang on.
Okay. All right. So your web bullet, you can make three attacks: one at 31, one at 26, one at 21.
Okay.
The numbers next to that is if you're attacking me, Spider-Man, because you have an advantage. You have a bonus to attacking me because you're Venom, and yeah. And if you're if you're ambushing somebody. So if you're ambushing Spider-Man, you get a plus 35. So it's a little confusing how I do it. Sneak attack requires that you actually be sneaky, like you're either flanking a person or you're sneaking up on them. So okay, you'll do a straight 14 damage for every bullet that hits.
Okay, so this is just the isn't it?
Yeah, you can.
And then adding it's the 1d20, and then adding the plus 31, plus 26, plus 21.
That is correct.
Gotcha. Okay. You know. 20.
Hit. But was it a natural 20?
Yeah, natural 20.
You crit.
And one. One.
Did you roll a one?
Yes.
That crit fails. Okay. Here's what happens. okay, your first web bullet crits and gets embedded inside the creature.
Gotcha.
The second one, your web fluid comes out and it actually gunks up your artificial web shooters, and it cancels out your attack for the round.
What?
Okay, your first
really?
Your first roll was a 20, right? A natural 20.
Yes.
Okay, and your next roll was a 1, right?
Yes.
Okay, yeah. So you crit and you critically hit and then you critically failed. You do a nice, beautiful critical damage, and then I have to fuck you because it's my job as the Dungeon Master to fuck you because you crit failed. So, yeah. So your left. Let's just say you're doing this with your left. Well, okay, actually, yeah, actually.
I'm left-handed, so it
you
works.
Can do it with both hands. Okay, tell you what. I will gunk up one of your artificial web shooters. So it depends which hand. So, okay, you're in order to use, like, pick one, left or right?
Right.
Okay.
I like my left hand.
Okay, your right hand is gunked up, and before you can use that web shooter again, you need to take an action to clear it. And literally, just like taking an action, your symbiote will automatically clear it. But you're going to have to, you basically have to eat a turn in order to do that. But meanwhile, your left hand is still good. So you can make your other attack with your left hand.
Okay, I'll make the other attack with the left hand.
Because, again, you're a Spider-Man character, meaning you can just stand on the wall like you have gravity there if you want to. So you could stand, look towards the spider and just be like, just shoot webs at it if you want to. So you hit it once. Go ahead and make your next attack.
Okay. 6.
Plus 21 hits. So you've dealt 14 times 3 damage, which is 42. Dealt 42 damage to it. Do some calculations real quick. Okay. Nicely done. All right, so you fire a bunch of webbing at it, just blah, blah. You fire two web bullets and they pierce into the creature's body and it howls in pain. It's Spider-Man's turn. Spider-Man's webbed it up and Spider-Man is also going to fire a web bullet. At a plus 17. And I should probably actually roll a d20 instead of a d6. 21 hits. Spider-Man is also standing next to you, and he fires a web bullet at the thing. He deals 8 damage to it. And just kind of bludgeons the thing, and it yelps. Okay. It is going to It needs to get out. I think the webbing hardened. Hold on, let me double check Spider-Man.
Can we hold? I gotta go turn on my phone.
Okay, I gotta do something anyway.
Bye. It would be Jonathan Joestar would be a first kiss, but nay, it was I, Dio Brando.
You can't handle the power of my stand, Dio. Star Platinum will destroy you. That was perfect. Okay, so we're back, and Arsenius has joined us.
I'm just here for commentary, as I am partaking in religious study as well.
Yes. He's going to talk. Okay, so Alex, he's going to talk to you about Jesus for a minute. I hope that makes you feel uncomfortable. Good.
Most likely will, since I have to go to church in the morning anyway.
Yeah. Basically. I think I'm. I think I'm the most heathen one here, actually. But So where were we? Okay. So the giant spider, not able to break out of it, started moving its legs around. It bites down on Spider on the webbing, and it just tears and eats the entire webbing. And it's still on its side trying to right itself up. But it is now Lorelle.
Haha! You thought your computer would run, but no! As per Windows, it was I, Dio! An update!
Dio, you son of a bitch. How dare you? I will avenge Pomerath for what you've done. The secret of Dio's stand is to fuck up computer powers. That's what it is. Brilliant. I never would have seen it coming. No wonder his followers are so loyal.
His allow him to control computer up.
Jojo, this is nothing you've seen before! His power is too great for you! Your hacking abilities cannot succeed!
Star Platinum can hack faster than anything you can throw at me, Dio. Ugh, okay. Bad JoJo jokes. Anyway, okay.
Very bad, but very appropriate.
Yes. Okay.
I've been watching, as you can clearly tell, I've been watching JoJo's Bizarre Adventure for a few days.
Yeah, well, as you should. As you should. And I was actually watching the video you sent about Evangelion. And, I was interested in that video, and I'm all angry at, I'm angry at Anno again. You know, it's like I thought it's a pretty decent analysis, and it's just like, yeah, he is kind of saying this thing about, being immersed in fantasy, I guess, which maybe...
Too depressed. I'm sorry. He's too depressed. It's annoying.
It hits a little close to home, but at the same time, I feel like it's bullshit, because it's like, you know, I may play video games too much. I may play role-playing games too much. I may fuck around a little bit, but at the end of the day, I leave my house and go get things done. I'm sorry, I'm not gonna have a fucking a clinically depressed guy lecture me on on facing reality when, you know, he keeps on revisiting this crap over and over again. It's interesting though, hearing this guy talk about how I've heard a lot of positive response to the newer Ava movies more than anything else. I think the most negative I think you've probably heard has probably come from me just rolling my eyes at it, because I'm just an old codger who bitches about everything, and especially Evangelion. But,
I will personally say that the Evangelion Rebuild movies are good.
Yeah.
They're worth watching. They're nothing compared to the original series.
Yeah, and it's I feel like maybe it is true that maybe it's more kind of... I don't know, it's an interesting, dichotomy, where it's you're going from, you're shifting from, the very artsy, conceived from depression, bleak outlook in the original Evangelion, to a you know, to a more typical anime type feel in the newer stuff, which on the one hand is more satisfying and at the same time does feel a little more derivative. It's one of those things where to me it's all an alternate universe anyway, so it's like it doesn't. If this is what he wants to do, or it's the studio wants to do, they want to keep revisiting this and repackaging it, I don't see a problem with it. Again, it's like, on the one hand, I kind of see where he's coming from if part of his message is, you know, like, immersing yourself in fantasy is a bad thing. I can understand how I feel like doing it to an extreme is a problem. But at the same time, it's like, I feel like it's full of shit coming I feel like it's full of shit coming from Ono to some degree. It's like, I don't know. It's weird. It's like, you've gone from like a very artistic, very artsy, you know, standpoint that's kind of beautiful for what it is. And yet at the same time, not satisfying as it wasn't satisfying at the time as an ending and just very bleak to more traditional anime, but it's kind of lost that kind of darker edge to it. So it's interesting, but this has nothing to do with the game, so I have to edit now. Okay,
yeah.
All right, so where we left off, the spider basically kind of unable to break free from the webbings, it moves its legs up a little bit and basically bites down on the webbing and tears it open and eats the webbing. And it's now lying on its side. So it is Lorala's turn. And I was going to... Yeah, I had these nice handy-dandy new sheets I was going to use. There we go. All right, Lorala is going to make two attacks with a rapier on the spider and one bite attack. I need my...
Wait.
Yeah. What? Yes, sir? Yes?
There he is again. Okay.
All right.
What are y'all playing through?
We're 3.5. City of the Spider Queen.
Y'all are playing through City of... That's what I want to know.
Yeah. So you've done this before. So he's on the big giant web, where I think, yeah, with you guys it was Carver. Carver's barbarian just ran out in the middle of it and got stuck on it, and you had to fight a big giant spider.
I is spider web here. Swing sword.
And then
I loved his character because his wisdom score was ridiculously high, but his intelligence score was super low.
Yeah. Manlius McMaximus. The dumb brick who would just headbutt through
say
doors.
Something wise and meaningful out of nowhere.
Yeah. but
and have an unbreakable will.
But otherwise, he would just walk through walls and would just occasionally just headbutt his way through doors. And the last session he played with me, though, was the greatest, though, where he just, like, he murdered
everybody.
I was stupid, okay?
I went through the vampire crypt.
Oh, yeah, dude, he got... yeah, all right. So you remember that, like, mausoleum, like, right at the beginning that you never went inside?
Oh, God. I never went inside it, so I probably...
God.
Yeah, there was a vampire in there that you never fought, and no one has ever fought the damn thing before. Like it's always... It's just been sitting there. The only other person aside from him that's ever gone into it is that asshole Jason that Namoto and I told you about. And he, like, deliberately went in there because he wanted his character to become a vampire. Whereas, like, but I've been waiting... forever. And every time I've run, see the Spider Queen, go inside the mausoleum, go inside, there's vampires in there. And nobody, you never went in. You never touched the damn thing. You never even, I don't think you even looked at that mausoleum. You went to the other mausoleum, the boring one with nothing in it. You know, and you know, you made that into a fucking clubhouse where, you know, you put your dead space marine vampire spawn and Howington's character. But like, yeah, he went in and he got turned into a vampire. And he was already Genji from Overwatch, so he was a cyborg ninja vampire. And then he levels himself up as a Fremen. So he's the greatest Gary Stu bullshit character of all time. He's a cyborg ninja vampire Fremen. And then he immediately got eaten by the lions. Which I think he pissed off like two or three times. And then he got eaten by them. It was great.
It was horrifying.
It was beautiful.
So it was
horrifying.
You went through there and got turned into a vampire like that?
Yeah. Well, it was basically what I took a cue from Matthew Mercer.
Did you want to be turned into a vampire?
No. No, what happened...
I didn't know where I was going.
What happened was they dropped him, and it was either kill him or make him into a vampire and spare his character. So I rolled a D100, and I rolled high, so I decided to be merciful. For I am as generous as I am kind. And I decided, okay, the only way that he would ever be salvaged in this situation...
You mean you are as generous as you are fucked up in the head?
Yes. Yes. Much like Xerxes, the historical...
Much like Anno.
Yes, because I am too immersed in fantasy, because I'm playing D&D right now. It's true. It just it pisses me off because it cuts close to home. I think, you know, I ended the game last time way too happy. I think this time, your character needs to basically just be. I think you need to go inside the X mentality.
What is wrong with your character right now?
Right now he's Venom. But like he was this horrible Gary Stu. He was Genji from Overwatch.
Did your character die?
Yes, the lion. You remember the lion trap?
Died by the lions.
The lion trap right in the beginning. Which, by the way, our party, when we had other members in it, kept fucking with over and over again, because Dana, who was playing Beachcomber, like kept going in there and playing with them Beachcomber's into animals. So he would like somehow diplomacy the fucking lions down and just start playing with them like big cats. But they don't like Genji as much, so they just murdered him.
Bullshit.
So it was beautiful.
It was horrifying.
It was beautiful. And he kept walking back into it. I'm gonna go back into D5. He walked into it like three times, and then finally I killed him.
Damn. God, that was annoying.
Yes. But now he's
walking.
Now he's Venom from Spider-Man.
I got annoyed because I could never find the other guys as Genji.
No, he wandered around. He wandered down trying to catch up to where we're at, and he went to everywhere else but where we were located at. And I think he found out like when I made a video about it.
Thought the hole was a trap.
Yeah.
God, I thought that hole that you told me that I was supposed to go down was a trap.
Yeah, you thought it was a trap when really that was the place you were supposed to go through.
Yeah.
You had a choice. You had the wall or you had the hole in the ground, and you just chose the wall.
I'm annoyed. I'm annoyed at myself, but we're fixing it now.
Well, with Venom. Now Spider-Man and Venom are teaming up to fight Dungeons & Dragons.
They don't know I've pretty much eaten part of Venom's, part of Genji's leg, and that he's dead.
Don't tell Spider-Man you hate Genji.
He doesn't need to know.
Yeah. He ate, like, the first thing he does as Venom is he just eats part of Genji's leg. Because he finds Genji's dead body and is like, I'm just going to eat this guy and gain his power. Because that's an established power of Venom's.
I should have ate his head first. Damn.
Yes, because that totally would have made me give you powers from that. And memories.
His memories.
That's totally a character that, like, a power that you have that I wrote down in your character description, which I just, like, yeah, it's such a good power, I totally forgot to put it in there. Maybe because I didn't put it in there at all, because you can't do that.
Should be allowed to do that.
No. No. No.
Why?
You need
to... Why?
Go talk to a wizard and have him give you the power to do that. Or go talk to your buddy Norman Osborn, or Mr. Fantastic and have him give you the... I don't think Mr. Fantastic's going to give you the power to do that. But go, like, yeah, go... You need to develop that power, sir. You do not have that ability.
What power?
He thought he could just eat Genji's corpse in order to gain his knowledge. Which is not
the one that kept telling me that Venom could eat brains.
Venom does eat brains, but that's because Venom's fucked up. Venom doesn't actually gain anything from eating brains.
Stupid.
Yes. Stupid and crazy.
Very stupid.
Yes. Well, you're the one who chose to play Venom. You could have played... I did. You could have played Johnny Storm. You could have played Mr. like the Human Torch. He's a nice boy. He was played by Chris Evans in the last... in like a couple movies ago.
And you said somebody needs a wizard to gain that ability?
Yes.
Want to be able to eat people and get them? Are you about to join the party?
I mean, I am mostly listening in on this and offering commentary, but if Flutter Budgets is necessary, you can call on me. I can pull his character sheet up relatively quickly.
Okay, well, I should inform you, though, the starting level for this is... Because you're, like, epic. Starting level 16.
Well, Flutter Budgets is basically a god in your canon, so... And Time Traveler.
You'd have to depower him.
Flutter Budgets is a Time Traveler.
Okay. I mean, how
does he affect time? Is it like Harry Potter or what? How does the time effect thing work?
He's got, alright, so, Davis's playstyle is to cast Wish every 5 seconds, and 50% of the time it does something good, the other 50% of the time he destroys the world. So, one of the things that he did when that, like last time we played was he made a wish spell that gave him a magic wand that enables him to move through time. And,
it is 3 charges per day.
3 charges per day. He can move through time. And, he then immediately used it to destroy the space-time continuum as we know it. And drive himself crazy. I also, in that same campaign, I used it as an out for him. Because then I, was going to destroy the world. And there was, no way for him to fix it. So it was like, okay, we'd established that regardless of the fact that other things were, keeping people stuck in that universe as it was dying, time travel still worked. So he was able to use time travel to get out of it. But his boss was really mad at him, and they had an argument about it, and then his boss was going to dock his pay and actually take him to court over it. But he was able to, call Bay News 9, and Bay News 9 was able to actually, put a stop to that. And, of course, by that, I mean Nathalahotep tried to kill him, and he wound up summoning a bunch of gods, including the G.O.D., to save him, and Thanos with the Infinity Gauntlet, because my games are insane.
Which, that particular sequence of events caused Flutter Budgets to have a change of heart.
Yes. Now he's a Christian. Now he is Bible Man.
What the fuck, dude? Dude, the fuck?
Flutter Budgets went from being chaotic neutral to seeking a life of chaotic good.
Flutter Budgets, a man who had it all. Wealth, magic, success. Then one day, he lost it all. But then, at his darkest hour, Flutter Budgets found a wholly remarkable book, the Bible. Flutter Budgets now renewed with a desire to serve God. Flutter Budgets became Bible Man. Bible Man! Bible Man! With Doug Marston as Bible Boy. Bible Man!
You know, the funny part is that those roles should honestly be reversed based off their stature.
Yes. With the animal as Bible Girl. And Melmoto as the atheist.
You'll find that playing with us can create some very, very interesting things to happen.
Yes. I will
search for every way to avoid combat just because I find more fun in the flavor. And combat takes forever.
He prefers diplomacy and using wish spells. And that's why Animal hangs out with him, because Animal will ensure if I win initiative, he has no choice but to deal with combat. Because I'm I'm only good at one thing. Stab. and then he face palms, and it's like, fine, fireball. Delayed blast fireball. I hate you. I wanted to befriend the genocidal Nazis, but no.
I wanted to befriend them and show them the errors of their ways, but no, you had to stab one. Oh, holy shit.
Gave one of my last characters shit for blowing up a mind-controlled kobold. And it was on Christmas time, that was kind of shitty in me. But I had a really awesome grenade launcher, and I wanted to use it, so.
What the fuck is all this?
Our games are insane.
What the... God.
So anyway, Oh, yeah, I gotta...
Oh, Flutter Budgets is also a vampire.
Fuck?
He's a vampire and he's a Lovecraftian creature.
And an eldritch horror, that too.
Yes.
Oh, okay, so she was like Azathoth then.
Yeah, you can play Flutter Budgets, but you're gonna have to nerf yourself to level 16.
You know, the idea is that Flutter Budgets is only going to show up if he is called on to solve one problem and then just leave.
Okay. I'm welcome to have you jump into the game, dude.
I don't actually have the time to jump into the game tonight.
Okay. Well, I'll leave the light on for you.
That's the basis of the problem. There is that I don't have the time.
Okay. But I forgot what I was doing. I'm the best Dungeon Master ever.
Yes, clearly.
These are all very good-looking people.
11, 6, 5. Okay, that's what it was. All right, 23 hits, 14 misses, and 24 hits. Okay, so she managed to slash the spider once and bite it. And let me see. I did manage to save all my shit before you know everything exploded, so that's good.
Time that's happened.
Yeah, half the fun of my games is just like you know trying to make the game, just trying to like fight my own computer. 1d6+2, and where's my bite? Where's the bite? Where's my bite? 1d6. Okay. That's 2d6. Okay. She deals 8 damage to the spider. And it is Venom's turn.
Okay. So where am I right now?
You are standing on the side of the wall in front of the spider web. And you have been shooting web bullets at the spider, at the giant spider. And, it has just eaten its way through the webbing and is free, but it's standing on its side prone, and Lorala slashed it.
Okay.
It is standing on its side prone.
It's lying on its side prone. Shut up.
Okay. Is it dead?
It is not dead. It's howling and angry and mad.
I guess we could do, like...
Yes?
Kick it a few times.
You're gonna kick it?
Eh. Web grapple and kick it.
You're gonna web grapple and kick it.
Yes. Yes, I am. Can hear me even though I'm in another tab. Okay. Yeet. Silence. Ein. God, I'm stuck alone again. Here we go. Hello. Somebody speak before I.
There he is. I don't know why, but Mario Brothers' random tidbits of music have been stuck.
Seriously, get a new computer, dude. This is annoying. The silence.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I've gotta satisfy his viewers. Viewers.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. God damn. All right.
Oh, I don't like having to satisfy your viewers with my inane chatting.
Hey, Eddie.
What?
Eddie,
yeah.
Do me a favor.
Yeah.
Open up Task Manager.
Okay. The Task Manager's open.
How many things do you have running in the foreground?
Well, just I've got Discord, I've got Google Chrome, I got three notepads, photos, and Windows Explorer.
Google Chrome's your problem.
I know. I don't have my dice today. I have to use the random number generator.
Use Firefox.
Okay.
Google Chrome is so RAM hungry.
It's typically Google Chrome. I know. I'm so used to using Google Chrome.
Causes a I used it for years, and then I started seeing how where I was having performance issues, and when I stopped using Google Chrome, I realized just how much it was affecting my computer.
Mm-hmm. This normally would be a problem if my phone were working.
Your second thing is with Discord is I find that if you leave it, like if you close out of it,
mm-hmm.
you don't go and shut down all the background processes. There's like five different Discord background processes that keep running all the time.
Yeah.
And every time I have communication issues that don't seem to be connection related from my end, I just go and close out Discord. I close out all of those background processes and then I reopen Discord and it fixes it.
Okay. Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Okay, good. Yeah. I thought it might be the microphone for a minute and so I unplugged it. Okay. Yeah, fuck Google Chrome. I still use it though because it's useful for me for some things, but it's whatever. Okay. All of my hate. Anyway, Venom. Are you going to web grapple the spider?
Sure. Eddie.
Why?
He's dead. We have to.
No, I don't think we need to bury him and move on. I think we just need to show him love and compassion so that
I will castrate you both. Now look, Genji.
I was gonna offer you a hug, okay?
Then we're even.
This man wanted to bury you and move on.
That's true.
I will show you love and compassion, you piece of shit.
Woodhouse, I need another drink. And a mirror. A needle and thread. A bowl and a straight razor. We are not emasculating Krieger. What was the mirror for? So you could watch.
What?
Anyway, I was Archer joke. Anyway, okay. Genji, you're gonna web grapple. You're gonna web grapple the fucking spider.
Yes.
Do it. Alright, what'd you get? Okay, plus 31.
Hey, I got a response to this one.
What'd you get?
I have plus 31. That's, 36?
36. Okay. You have grappled the spider. He is grappled with your webbing.
Okay.
That's all you can really do this round, though.
Okay.
Okay. Spider-Man. And I don't have my... Where's my character sheet? Oh my god. What the fuck? Alright, here it is.
There we go, good. Got it.
Okay. Alright. Spider-Man is going to web-sling and kick the thing in the face. So he's just gonna, like shoot a web line to the ceiling and swing forward and kick it in the face. So I have a plus 34 to hit. Um, 41 I hit. 1d3 plus 23. 24 damage. Okay. And I need a calculator real quick. Um,
Yeah, there's a lot.
What? Okay. Can you hear me? Oh my god. God damn it. Oh my god. God damn it.
This is true.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, before I throw my computer out a goddamn window and smash it. All right, Spider-Man webs the ceiling, kicks the giant spider in the face. That's his move. Okay. And the spider itself. Okay, the spider is going to write itself up, and since Spider-Man was the last person to attack him, he's going... No. All right, you've actually grappled him. So he's going to try to break out of the grapple. So you need to make a strength check.
Okay, that would be 62 plus 26.
Hold on, that doesn't sound right.
That's what's here.
No. You're going to use your modifier. You have a plus 26.
Oh, the modifier. Yes. Okay.
So, it's still insanely high, but, you know.
What do you have a plus 26 for in?
He's a Marvel character converted into D20. As I've said, they're insane. His stats are, he's got, like, as long as he's got the suit on, he's a 62 strength. He could pick up a giant and throw it at people. Other than that, he has an 18 dexterity, a 20 constitution, a 13 intelligence, 17 wisdom, and a 19 charisma.
Fun.
Yeah. Do you already roll?
I forgot I have to roll.
Yes.
Hang on. X.
What'd you get?
X. So that's crap. I can't do this quick math right now. Damn it, give me a minute. Calculator, help me.
Alright, I rolled a 14. Did you roll a 6?
Yes, I rolled a 6.
Okay, I can do it. You won.
Hey.
You got a 22. Alright, so it tries to break free of the webbing it can't. You're holding it fast, so it's stuck. Rala is going to lay into it with her sword and a bite. 14 misses, 18 hits, and a 7 misses. Okay, it tries to scuttle away from her. She slices it one time, and she deals 6 damage to it. All right, Venom, it is your go.
Okay. Oh, we're gonna... I'm grappling it right now, so don't bite it.
It's too far away. What you're doing right now is you're holding it in place with your webbing.
Okay.
It's too far away from you for you to bite it.
Okay,
you'd
understood.
You'd have to move to it in order to bite it.
Mm, okay. Is the cleave?
What is cleave?
Yes.
All right, cleave is basically when you drop If you drop an enemy, like you knock it like to zero or below, the attack you drop it with, you can then attack an adjacent enemy to it as well. So if you have Great Cleave, you can basically regular Cleave, you can only hit one opponent that's next to it. If you have Great Cleave, you can hit that opponent, and then if you drop that opponent, then you can go to the next opponent and so on and so forth. You can basically do like a big like tornado attack essentially. And like you could basically drop a bunch of enemies if you score high enough for it.
Okay. Yeah.
It's just web bulleted again.
You're gonna web bullet it? Okay. Shoot your web bullets. Actually that's a problem. You've got one of your artificial web shooters is gunked up. The other one you are holding it in place with the webbing. So you have to either let go of the grapple, or you have to clear the artificial gauntlet on the other hand.
I'm gonna clear the gauntlet.
Okay, that's your move. You basically clear it. Spider-Man basically is gonna hang from the ceiling from one web line, and he's going to entangle the giant spider again. So. Let's see. All right, where did I? Plus 17. Okay. Thirty-three. I hit. It is entangled once again. Okay, so it's grappled by you, and it's
entangled by Spider-Man.
Yeah, it's got a better chance of breaking my entanglement than anything else.
Can't break the grapple.
No. But it can start eating my webbing, and it deals 11 damage to it. Okay, it starts eating the webbing. It's almost broken through, but it's like my webbing still got one more hit point, so it'll be out the next turn. But it can't escape just yet. All right, Lorala, chop chop bite. 17 for the first hit misses. Second one is 13 misses, and she whiffs all three times. It starts rolling around, and she keeps slashing at it but misses. It's your move.
Okay. So it's still eating through the web shooter's fixed now at this point.
Yeah, I mean it basically can't move, but it's trying to eat through the webbing that I just put it in.
Web bullet.
Okay, you've got a free arm, so you can make your attacks.
Yeah, let's do it. Team?
You rolled an 18? You gotta speak
31.
Up. Okay. 31 total?
18 plus 31.
Okay, you hit.
And the second one?
Mm-hmm.
4.
Hit.
And the third one? 12.
You hit.
Hit.
Okay, so you do 14 times 6. That's another 42 damage. And you fire three web bullets into the thing, and it pelts it over and over again, and it starts bleeding and falls unconscious. And then it makes a guttural sputter, and it stops struggling. Okay. You have defeated the giant fiendish spider. But let's be honest, the real enemy today was not the giant fiendish spider. The real enemy was Discord, Google Chrome, my computer, the most cruelest enemy of all. That was the real enemy we had to fight. And just overall, just any time I try to make a video, it's a war. It's a fucking war, man.
Upgraded or get like a new computer completely.
Fuck you.
Saying.
That's not an option, all right?
Have people that can help you upgrade your computer.
Okay. Well, we'll talk. I'd be interested in that. Okay, so...
I could get you one for less than $500. So it would be probably 10 times better than what you've got.
I have 3 of them. All in various states of repair.
I'm talking about, like, a full-on desktop computer that you would be able to do everything on and not have to worry for, like, 3 years.
Okay, I don't really have a place to put a desktop right now.
I can get you a really tiny one.
Okay.
I can get you one small enough that you could actually carry it.
Noted. We'll
discuss this topic.
Let's not talk about my computer problems right now. Let's just pray that I don't have any more for the rest of the night. Before rocks fall and everybody dies. Including Clutterbuddy somehow, who's not even in the game yet.
Oh, Flutterbudgets wouldn't die from rocks falling on him. He'd just fart cloud away.
Yeah, for some reason he's unable to this time and just dies. A vengeful asshole god takes his vengeance on him. Anyway, alright, are you looking at the map?
Oh wait, no, I don't have access to the map. Oh wait, hang on, wait.
You have a map.
Give me a moment.
God damn.
Give me moments.
Okay.
To you.
Okay. Google Chrome just is gonna cut me off again. Hang on. You guys can still hear me, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay, good.
Christian. Found it. Yay. Oh god. Figuring out how to use this thing.
Okay, are you looking at the map?
Yes, I am.
Okay. All right, so you're kind of near S4 right now. That's where you're on the wall near S1. Spider-Man is kind of hanging in the air above. And and like Lorala is floating. You notice like she's got little wings on her boots and which is enabling her to fly. And the spider is unconscious just like right next to S4. That's where you're at. Spider-Man says, "It's like, well, that was fun. Okay, see you at the center of the web."
Yeah, sure.
Okay, he's going to start web swinging toward the center of the web, and he's about halfway there. What are you going to do? Lorala follows him.
Follow him then. To do anyway.
How are you going to get there?
Web. Swing? Yeah.
Okay. You're all going to web swing to S12. Okay. Everybody web swings to S12. And I'm going to... Oh, that's right. I lost the... lost my book when I had to close the thing down. So I got to open it up again. Okay. All right, talk to me about this desktop, Davis.
Well, I can go online and look for parts and whatnot that could add up to build a computer.
See, I think I've talked about this with Malmoto before. I think the really issue is just my connection's not that good, and it's like I'm living with some people, so it's like I don't really have control over the internet. I think I don't think there's anything really I can do about it right now.
That could also be an issue.
Because my computer's overall, other than the fact, this computer is pretty good other than the fact that it's Windows 10. For Windows 10, it works pretty good. It's like, you know, it's like the smaller laptop that I got Ubuntu put on, like that, like Windows 10 is god-awful. It just like, it might just be it has like lower memory. It works great with Ubuntu, but like this one's like there's a minimum of problems. Every now and then it decides to like do something stupid, like freeze up and install an update I don't want. But other than that, it's like it works pretty well. It's just kind of a pain in the ass, though. All right, we're at S12. Okay, so you web sling over to the center of the spider web, and you notice that at the exact center there's like the webbing is stuck to a large cave opening, and you guys land on the cave opening and look inside. And inside, this huge natural cavern seems overlarge for a single clump of creatures gathered near its southwest wall. Two lizards loaded down with packs and crates stand at the center of the clamp. Three gray dwarves beside them seem to be selling wares from the lizard's packs. The customers include a pair of drow, a trio of kutaos, and a mind flayer. A ledge about 10 feet off the ground runs the length of the northeastern wall, and some half dozen doors are set into the wall beyond the ledge. The cavern ceiling is about 20 feet high. And again, you're new to all this, so it's like if you want me to describe what these things look like, I can do that. But
yes.
Okay. So again, there's apparently some giant lizards that are being used like pack mules. There are some stocky fellows that appear to look like dwarves, but they have gray skin. You're familiar with the drow at this point, and the kutoas are these weird looking frog people, and the mind flayer is a tall, gaunt looking gentleman who has a squid for a face.
Oh, so he's just Davy Jones then?
Yes. He doesn't have a mouth over the squid tentacles, like Davy Jones. And you're not sure if he's voiced by Bill Nighy, but he might be.
Okay. That seems like something I don't need to get into.
Okay.
So I'm probably just going to move on.
Move on to where?
Maybe to S37, is that? I think that's 37.
Let me take a look. See, now all my stuff is a jumbled mess. All right, okay, so how are you going to get there?
Cut off again. Are you here?
I'm here. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay, well, how are you going to get to 37? You're in a web sling. Okay. Spider-Man web slings and Lorella flies. S37. Okay.
Hey, so what's going on here?
Okay.
He's gonna pull it up.
A yawning hole in the chasm wall opens into a well-crafted room with smooth walls and floor. The far portion of this chamber curves into an octagonal shape. Two passages lead out of the room through the craft archways, and a narrow tunnel seems to form an exit through the ceiling. A ladder that strongly resembles a spider web leads up to the tunnel. Up to the tunnel mouth, excuse me. And let me... I think I probably have a different map for this one.
If you do, just send it to me over Discord.
Okay.
Well, the major thing with his maps is that if he doesn't find one for the individual room, he's going to find one for the whole area, and that's all he can send.
He knows. He's seen what I've been able to send.
Okay.
So, feel like I'm kind of getting the system laced with City of the Spider Queen from now, but I don't know. It feels more efficient. I don't know if it actually is, but...
There's one module that I wouldn't mind picking up and running.
Yeah.
Just based off the name.
Yeah.
It's called Tomb of the Iron Medusa.
I have that.
It was a Pathfinder module, though.
Was that? I think didn't you recommend Tomb of the Iron Medusa to me?
I haven't actually read through it. I've probably voiced that I'd like to pick it up and run it if I could.
Yeah.
It is a level 14 campaign, so you'd need people who understand what's going on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah, no, I've actually wanted to run that myself. I think, like, I'm not sure if I talked to you about it, or I might have been Orlando on my ship. I think he wanted to run it. I think he misunderstood it, and he called it Tomb of the Iron Maiden, which is a great name. Okay, but you are in 237, and basically...
No, yeah. I think I said that. I think that was me.
That was you, yeah.
The Tomb of the Iron Maiden, I looked it up and was like, nope, it's Tomb of the Iron Medusa. My bad. Yeah.
But yeah, okay, so you're in S37 on this new map. And it's very... As described, it's very nice looking.
Yes.
Like, as it's all kind of polished stone and stuff like that. So that's where you're at. What you gonna do?
Let's take a look at the S-38s.
Alright, hold on. I have to kill you.
What? Why?
You'll find out.
Oh, I don't understand. Why do I have to die?
Because it's funny to me.
That's horrifying.
He likes killing players.
I do.
You're a horrible person.
I am. Okay. What's your alignment?
Hang on. Yeah. Do I have one?
You should. I don't know if I put it on your...
Where'd you put it? Because I don't see it.
I don't know if I put it on your sheet or not. Okay, I am looking at your sheet. Okay. I mean, I think you would probably be like, if I didn't put it down there, you could basically pick whatever alignment you wanted. I mean, in terms of like the character, Eddie Brock at this point, I think would be chaotic good. Flash Thompson would be either chaotic good or lawful good, and the symbiote would be chaotic evil. So you're probably neutral, but it depends on what you... Yeah, I don't think I put it down here. It is a point at a time. Okay, yeah, it can be whatever you want. What do you want your alignment to be?
You know what? I'm going to be... Let's go with... Lawful good, then.
Lawful good? Okay. Wow. Lawful good Venom.
That's such a weird thing, ain't it?
That makes absolutely no sense, but fine. It also doesn't make sense for a character who eats like a corpse, either. But whatever.
That was a moment. Neutral!
Yeah, I think neutral is the more sensible alignment, but it's his character.
Chaotic
he wants to be
neutral.
That's
that was a moment of weakness.
Chaotic neutral is probably the correct alignment, but it's his character, so I'm not gonna. Yep. I'm not gonna.
Wait, what the hell is chaotic neutral? I thought neutral was just neutral.
Well, it is.
So chaotic okay, is there's four sides to the alignment spectrum.
Yeah, you explain the alignment.
It basically works like a those four alignments combine into nine, or four major aspects of the alignments form into nine different main categories. So you've got lawful and chaotic being opposites of each other, and then you've got good and evil being opposites of each other. In that, if you look at it like a an XY grid, you could put chaotic all the way to the left, lawful all the way to the right, good all the way at the top, evil all the way at the bottom, and create nine segments. So you have neutral right in the middle, you've got neutral good all the way straight up, neutral evil straight down, lawful neutral straight to the chaotic neutral all the way to the left. And then in each corner, you've got lawful good, lawful evil, and chaotic evil, respectively.
Yeah. Are you married to being lawful good?
Hang on. Let me look at like a representation of this.
Just look up deity alignments.
Yeah, just let me.
We had that awesome picture when we first started the Discord.
Oh no, I didn't. We didn't have. I don't think we had that awesome picture. I think we had. I had nine.
I had the one that I posted in the thing, and it was great. And like, Joker was like chaotic evil and Palpatine was lawful evil, and you remember?
Oh, yeah.
It was great.
You guys still have that?
No, some fucker got rid of it because he changed the Discord spontaneously to, you know. Yeah, it was dumb.
Okay, I think I found one.
Okay. I'm looking at a bunch right now. I'm kind of trying to find the one I lost, but these are all good though. Okay. I have one.
Yeah.
I have an appropriate image, which I will send to you. I will send to you on Discord. There you go. Okay, so as you can see, lawful good equals Superman. Neutral good equals Captain Malcolm Reynolds. Chaotic good equals V for Vendetta. Lawful neutral is Captain Picard. He's lawful good. I disagree. True neutral is the Ents from Lord of the Rings. Chaotic neutral is Captain Jack Sparrow. That's very appropriate. Lawful evil is Darth Vader. Neutral evil is an alien xenomorph, and chaotic evil is the Joker.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
What was neutral?
Neutral is Treebeard. There's a lot of good ones here.
Chaotic neutral.
Okay. One of them used a bunch of fucking serial killers in their alignments. That's fucked up.
That's true.
That's not a fun meme.
Yeah. Ooh. Chaotic neutral. We're going chaotic neutral.
Chaotic neutral. Okay. I found another one, which I like. It's got Superman. Well, it's got my favorite chaotic neutral character, basically. I'll send it.
Anyway.
All right, you pick chaotic neutral? Yep. Okay, again, Superman, lawful good. Neutral good is Batman. Chaotic good is Rorschach. Lawful neutral is Judge Dredd. True neutral is Cable. Chaotic neutral is Deadpool. Lawful evil is Lex Luthor. Neutral evil is Dr. Doom. Chaotic evil is the Joker. So,
crap. Damn it.
Yeah. But, okay, so you are chaotic neutral. Okay, as a result, you need to make a will save.
Okay, so that would be...
Save of the will.
So I roll and then I add 8 to it.
Yes.
2.
2? 10?
Yeah.
Sadly, that is not high enough. Okay. So, what happens to you?
I need to change my alignment.
You attempt to walk into the room. And the moment you try to walk into the room, you are you feel a powerful force slam you back, you take 3d6 points of damage.
Ooh.
So.
Yeah. Die six.
Yes, you've taken 4 damage.
Yeah.
So I rolled for shit, so that's good. I think you have a healing factor too, actually.
Do. But I think it's only for like sound and fire.
No, you have regeneration, which means in order to do
regeneration.
Okay. All damage dealt to you is subdual damage. In order for me to actually hurt you, I need to use fire or sound.
Yeah.
So you're at 166, and
next let's good see. Thing to be done.
Let me take a look. Where's your regeneration? Yeah, so in one round you'll be completely healed. But some kind of force blasts you and knocks you back, and wounds you. And if you just want to sit and wait, you'll instantly heal.
Wait.
Okay. You wait 6 seconds and you feel better. But yeah, something definitely bitch slapped you and knocked you out of there. And you're like, what? And Spider-Man says, well, I don't need a spider sense to know that something dangerous is in there. What do you want to do?
I don't know. Good question. I'm not going to try walking back in there again because I'm just going to get hurt.
Spider-Man looks to Lorala. It's like, do you know anything about this place? And she says, yes. Darina Saran rules this city of Zithmor Kane. She's placed a forbidden spell. Only one with, well, a similar morality to my people would be able to enter there. If you're surface dwellers, your ways are, well, you can't walk easily. If your will's strong enough, you can overcome it. But if not, well, it'll be very painful for you to try to enter there, as you've seen.
Can I try messing with my morality again?
No, now that you've picked your alignment, it's set.
So I am chaotic neutral then?
You are chaotic neutral now.
So I can't enter this place then?
You could try again, if you want.
Okay, I guess. I know I said I wasn't gonna, but at the same time, I feel like I should be there.
Ooh, make another will save.
And will saves. 18.
Is that including your plus 8?
Oh, the 18, and then add 8 to that.
Okay. That would be a... that'd be a 26. Okay, you enter and you feel like a malevolent evil presence wanting to force you back, but you're like, no, screw you, I'm coming in here. And you hold on, you enter, and it wears off. You're not able, it's not able to push you out. So you've been able to cross. Spider-Man just kind of shrugs and is like, all right, well, I don't like this at all. Here goes nothing, I guess. And he tries to cross too. No, he didn't make it. Yeah, it's a 19. Okay, so Spider-Man enters and Pwah! He gets knocked back. And I want to say he's chaotic good. But I put down for his alignment. If I put down anything. I'm not sure. I don't think I put it. Yeah, he's chaotic good. So I think it's going to be like the same type thing. He takes like 3d6. He gets hedged out. Yeah, that's exactly what happens. Spider-Man takes 6 damage. All right, so yeah, Spider-Man's at 39. That's not good. Spider-Man gets knocked back and is like looks burned and like badly and is like, ugh. I don't know about this. I don't know if I'm in any condition to go in any further. Lorala is going to try to go in. I think she's actually... She probably can actually get in. No, she's neutral evil. So... She probably has to make a save. Yeah, she does. What's her will save? Will save. Oh, her will save is a plus 3. Shit. Six. All right. She tries to enter, and boom, she gets bitch slapped back too. She takes 3d6.
So far, I'm the only one in there.
You are the only person that appears to be able to enter. Oh. Well, now I know why I'm rolling shit, actually.
Are you rolling shit?
I'm rolling shit because I did the... God, I missed my dice. All right. Yeah, you lucked out. I fucked up on the net random number generator. Okay, so she takes 6 damage.
Okay, so...
78. Okay, she's at 72 health. She gets up in pain. It's like, and Spider-Man looks in. It's like, Eddie, I don't think we can go in there with you.
All right, this shouldn't take long.
Are you sure? It's like, I don't want to abandon you, man, but I just like, I think I need to rest up. I don't think I'm in any condition to help out right now.
No, I understand. It's okay.
Okay, if you run into serious trouble, come back here, man, and we'll go back to the surface and like rest up or something. I mean, you don't have to do this right now. We could all just like, you know.
I'm here. May as well.
All right, I'll see if I can find another way in. Maybe I don't know.
Yes.
Okay. Try that. All right. Venom is on his own. Okay, what are you gonna do?
Okay. So,
don't you know you never split the party? Clerics in the back, take the spiders, fail and hardy. Wizards in the middle, where you can shit some. Go ahead. Okay.
So, these S-38s.
Okay.
Clerics should not be designated healers with the amount of damage that they can do.
It's true. Well, no, that's their point, that's their job. You're going to S-38. Okay.
You realize that they can uncard damage with a wizard, right?
Okay. Before you go any further, though, you notice that there are 4 creatures that are near the entrance, and as you start moving in further, you notice them. They're like just out of sight, but they're right at the front. They're horrible looking creatures. They have no skin. And their bodies are dripping blood. What they have left of their ears is slightly pointed, and they snarl at you as you approach.
They are horrible-looking creatures. That tells me a lot.
I fucking hate you guys. They're horrible-looking creatures with no skin.
Are they humanoid?
They're Kuthmarin, dude. Okay.
Grab that to me.
Okay, you're not here. Okay. Alex, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay. There are 4 humanoid creatures that have no skin, and they're dripping blood. They seem to have claws, and they have pointed ears. And they snarl at you as you approach. I can't do anything about the fucking connection, guys. You know, there's nothing I can... It's gonna crap out every now and then.
No, that wasn't out of the connection. That was out of the descriptors that you were using.
I said they had no fucking skin.
You said they were horrible-looking creatures, not
horrible
they were
horrible-looking creatures that had no fucking skin. Pay attention. Go to your room.
I'm going to try and move past them.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to try and move past them.
Okay, roll initiative. They see you.
Look, them trying to kill me.
No, they want to give you a hug.
I don't believe that. I don't believe that for you a fucking second.
You shouldn't believe that.
16 plus 4, 20.
Okay, you have a 20. Hold on, let me get their stats. Okay. Okay. All right. And They're in the back of this book, so I gotta go find them real quick. Okay, Revenant, good morning. All right, they have a plus one initiative, so... Oh, well, I just realized, I can show you what they look like. Better, you know. So... I want to post this in the Hangout Lounge if you guys want to see it. So, go check it out. That's what they look like.
Oh, God, that's disgusting.
Yep.
So the way to describe this.
Hey.
A group of forbidden standing before you with large pointy ears and no skin. They seem to be dripping out of their mouths some green ooze, their eyes white and piercing. Their hands seem to have elongated nails similar to that of claws, and their feet do not seem to have any sort of... do not seem to match. You do not make out many details or features of their face, but you can tell that they do look at you with anger. Resentment. Perhaps they seek their former selves.
Anger, resentment. Elsewhere in the universe, Flutterbudgets gets terrible irritable bowel syndrome and begins shitting all night.
I should just change my name on here to Flutterbudgets because everyone knows who that character is.
Yes. I'm gonna roll initiative for your buddies because they can attempt. They can see. They might be able to like do something from range. Yeah, because you're not out of earshot yet. So, and they just literally can't go in there to help you. That's the problem. And oh, she got a high initiative. She got plus 8.
I wonder. Can I put how many characters can I have for my username?
I don't know. Okay, Venom, it is your go. These you're gonna try to walk past these guys? Okay. Let me take a look at the map real quick. So basically they're on if you're looking at the map, they're like right before you get to the doorway. They're like on both sides, so there's plenty of room for you to move past them. So, you successfully. What's your movement?
Let's see. Hang on.
It's under your speed.
Oops, man. Okay.
Wait. I mean, your basic speed is probably 30 feet, and your web swing is also 30 feet. So it's like, so like, how are you gonna move? Are you gonna walk or run? What are you gonna do?
I'm gonna walk.
All right, you basically just walk right past them, and you're starting making your way to S18. If you do so, you'll be like right in front of the doorway and right next to one of them.
Oh, you can only have 32 characters.
Okay.
I can't put Flutterbudget's full title on here.
Shit. How about F Budgets?
There we go, that works.
No, yeah. I can put Flutterbudget's. I can't put the rest of, like, everything that comes afterwards.
No, of course not!
Dear God, no, that would be way too long.
Yeah.
Flutterbudget, self-proclaimed master of sneaky wizardry, death-defying bath, ruiner of day, and vanquisher of your sex life.
I'm gonna get a picture of a ham and send it to you.
Okay. Yeah, let's go to S38.
Okay.
Well, the first one closest to me, anyway.
Enjoy a slice in the Hangout Lounge. Okay, so you you've ended your movement just beyond the Kuth Marin, and you're right next to one, right in front of the doorway. That's as far as you can move per round. Okay. So
they're going to try and attack me.
Well, they look snarling and angry, like they're about to attack you. And you're like, I'm just gonna casually walk past them because, you know, I'm Venom and I'm groovy. I just it's kind of mellow, you know. No bugs, yeah. You know. No hang-ups, man.
Sometimes I wonder what life would be like if Venom was stoned.
I'm assuming you already are stoned, given the fact that you like to eat people. Among other things. All right, Spider-Man is going to try to snipe some of these things and keep them off your back. So Spider-Man is going to shoot a web bullet at the closest Kuth Marin to him. So
okay.
That's what he's going to do. And where's my web bullets? Where's my web? Oh, I have a captured. Yeah, okay. All right. Plus 17. All right. Uh, 28. I think that hits. It does hit. So he pelts one with a web bullet. And takes 8 damage. Okay. All right. So he shoots one in the face and like it's about to turn and snarl at you, but he shoots it right in the face. And it snarls and looks back at him. Lorala has some kind of a range attack, but I can't remember what it is. Plus one shadow set of leather scimitar. I have wand of magic missile. All right. How much, like, what does a first level magic missile do again, Davis?
Magic missile?
Yeah.
What level of magic missile?
One.
First level spell magic missile fires 3 missiles at the target. They do not miss as long as the target is not obstructed.
Okay.
And does not have any other effects that specifically state magic missile would not hit them.
Okay.
It does 1 die 4 plus 1 damage each
one
missile.
1 die 4 plus 1 damage each missile. Okay. So
preparing it at higher levels would allow you to fire more missiles.
Okay.
If I'm not mistaken. I believe that's the case.
Okay. 9 damage.
In the case of I say preparing it at higher levels because you can use meta magic feats that would allow you to prepare at higher levels. But you could up the damage, you could up the number of missiles, etc., etc. I think there's ways to do that in 3.5.
Okay.
I know in 5th edition, you can, as your character levels up, the spell also levels up.
Mm-hmm.
It starts at 1 missile, and every couple of levels, it gains another missile.
Okay. Do we know how much a wand of magic missile like charges would have?
It's a first level missile. What level is the wand?
Let me double check. Just wand of magic missile, first level caster.
So the way you assign what spells or how many charges of a particular spell go into a magic item like a wand.
Yeah.
Depends on how many levels the wand is capable of carrying. A wand of magic missile would have 3 spell levels on it. Therefore, it could have 3 first level spells on it.
Okay.
Meaning you could have 3 charges of magic missile per day.
Okay. So she can do this, like, just, she can do this two more times, and that's all she can do, basically.
That's
all
just right. an example. Now, the specific item might be different in the book or online. I have to look that up.
Okay.
And I can look that up for you.
All right. Thank you, sir. Yeah, okay, so she pulls out her Wand of Magic Missile, and she blasts, fires three bolts into the same Kuth Barin that Spider-Man hit, blasts the crap out of him, and he's still standing, though.
Okay.
So, all right, I mean, technically all of us would count as intruders. I mean, you've broke past their lines, but I have some options here on people I can kill. So, can be fair about this. Okay. So.
I got one for you.
Mm-hmm.
This wand has seven charges. While holding it, you can use an action to expend one or more of its charges to cast the magic missile spell from it. For one charge, you can cast the first level version of the spell. You can increase the spell slot level by one for each additional charge you expend. The wand regains 1d6 plus 1 expended charges daily at dawn. If you expend the wand's last charge, roll a d20. On a 1, the wand crumbles into ashes and is destroyed.
Okay.
Now, I believe this would be from D&D 5th edition.
Okay.
It is on dndbeyond.com. But you could essentially say for additional charges, you can cast it with an extra number of missiles to go along with it.
So what you're basically saying is, since even though I'm playing 3.5 right now, I should cheat and basically use the 5th edition version so I have 7 charges on it. I agree. That's what I'm going to do. So
I mean, it is your game. You can do whatever you want to and say that okay. It has 7 charges on it, and it regains a certain number per day.
Okay. All right. So the Kuth Barin get mad, and they actually totally ignore you, Venom, and they're going to actually charge Spider-Man and Lorala. The Kuth Barin that's next to you just moves away from you. And three of them gang up on Lorala, and one of them attacks Spider-Man. So the one attacking Spider-Man is going to... he is going to slam Spider-Man. Two slams. He's going to go up and just... He's going to charge him and just, like, punch Spider-Man right in the face. And... All right, so 17 and 18. Miss. He comes charging at Spider-Man. Spider-Man starts, bobbing, weaving, and dodging. Lorala, on the other hand, what are they going to do? Command a dead, horrifying gaze. The first one comes up and howls at her and is going to use its horrifying gaze ability. And a living creature within 30 feet that meets Quith Marin's death gaze was succeeded a will save DC 17 or cower in fear. Lose dexterity bonus to AC, unable to act at any foe, and gains +2 on attack rolls. All right, so she needs to make a DC will save 17. And... +3. 9, no. It howls at her, and she, like, looks into it and starts freaking out, and, like, it's like, no, no, please, sister, don't hurt me! And she starts cowering. And, yeah, she's got some penalties now. Yeah.
That's...
Loses her DC... she loses her DC bonus, and +2 on attack rolls. Okay, the second one is going to spit blood at her. And that's a range attack. It doesn't say though. Okay. Attack is a range increment of 10 feet with a maximum range of 5 feet. Glob deals 2d6 points of acid damage on a direct hit and 2 points of splash damage to a creature roll of it. It sounds like I still have to make a range attack for it, though, and it doesn't list the range attack on these things. I guess it's just +9. Or what's my dex? Okay, well, whatever. All right. Yeah, it hits her. Spews acid on her. And, oh. Did it again. Alright, she takes 12 damage from that hit.
And...
oh, they're completely ignoring me.
They are completely ignoring you. Okay, like while she's cowering, one of them spits acid on her, and she starts, you know, hits her on the shoulder and starts howling in pain. And then another one's going to come up and start beating the shit out of her.
Oh boy, okay. Can't just let them attack her?
What?
Come on. I'm going to try and get them off her.
Okay, the last one that tries to attack her basically runs up and charges her, but then trips and falls face like face first on the ground. And he's now prone. Because he crit failed. Alright, so yeah, it's your go. Are you gonna go run to Lorala's aid?
Yeah.
Okay, what are you gonna do?
Web entangle.
You're gonna web entangle?
Yeah.
Alright, which one are you gonna hit?
The one spitting blood.
Okay. All right, you can actually entangle three. You can use your entangle three times actually.
Yeah, I'll do that then. Okay. I'll entangle the two hurting her and maybe the one that Spider-Man's fighting.
On top of that, your sneak attack damage will apply because they're ignoring you.
It's true. Okay.
Okay, so you're gonna hit all three that are the one attacking Spider-Man and the two that are standing that attacked her.
Yes.
Okay, make your roll.
Yeah. 18.
That ham needs to go on a sandwich.
Okay. 18 plus 34.
Yes.
That hits.
Ham sandwich.
And then next one. 19.
That hits.
One. Third one is 8.
That still hits. Okay. All right. So you've web entangled all three of them. So they're all they're entangled. They fall to the ground. The impact damages them, so they all take 4 damage. And roll your sneak attack, 8 die 6.
Okay. We're supposed to roll a 6-sided die 8 times, right?
Yes. Or in this case, make the minimum in your random number generator 6, and the maximum 48.
6 and 48.
Right. What's that?
38.
All right, 38. You add 4 to that, so that'd be 42. All right. We'll say that was the one attacking Spider-Man.
Okay. 21.
21, that's 25. So, all right. And last one.
Okay. 21.
21, that's 25. So, okay. All right, so here's what happens. You fire 3 web blasts at them. The two that are on Lorala, you slam into their back and they get tangled up and fall to the ground and start howling. The one near Spider-Man ducks out of the way right when you fire it. It hits him in the back and he launches off the ledge and flies out into the chasm. And it's going...
Oh.
Yeah. Oh. So it just like... just like howls as it's being knocked away. Spider-Man. Okay, Spider-Man. There's... one more that isn't bound up, that is on the ground. He's going to web entangle that one so that they're all tied up like pigs in a blanket.
Okay.
And,
One. I mean, he did get the web entangled, but that one just died.
Yes. Okay, he entangles the other one. All three of the Kuthmaren are entangled. So, Lorala is going to... I think I need to make a will save to overcome the effects of the horrifying gaze. I need to make a 17 on my will save. So she's still cowering in fear. Let's see. She's still freaking out. She's you know, she's frantically wiping the blood off of her, the acid off her. But she's pretty much beside herself. Meanwhile, Spider-Man's webbing has 12 hit points. Your webbing is different. Your webbing has something. Your webbing has 14 hit points. Let's see. Caustic blood. Kuthmaren's natural attack deals an additional 1d6 points of acid damage from the creature's caustic blood. Hitting Kuthmaren with a natural weapon or unarmed attack takes 1d6 points of acid damage. Okay, by virtue of just sitting there, their acid blood starts melting away the webbing.
Okay.
Alright. 5, 6... And 4. All right. Yeah, they're just they're starting to the acid's starting to dissolve the webbing that you've encased them in, and now they can do something about that. So I could either do a strength check to break out or an escape artist check. It's a 24 for both. 24 to, like, the first one's going to try to break it. That's only a +4, though. Yeah, okay, +4. I had the crit, though. +20, but not natural. Okay, one of them tries to break out, he can't. Another one. 24. Yeah, another one tries to untangle himself, can't do it. The last one, the one that Spider-Man hit, and this is what I should have done in the first place, just looks down and spits at the webbing. And that's what he's going to do. Oh, didn't notice that. Two dice six, okay. He spits at the webbing and it completely dissolves. He's that the one that Spider-Man webbed down is now free. And one more thing with these suckers. I was unaware they could do that. Okay, Venom, you're back up.
Okay.
One of the Kuthmaren has gotten free, but he hasn't stood up yet.
Okay. I can web grapple?
Which one are you gonna web grapple?
The one just sitting there?
They're all sitting there.
Oh. The one that got free.
So you're going to web grab the one that got free. Go ahead. What'd you get, sir?
The number is 8.
Okay. Plus your attack?
Yeah.
Which would be?
21.
21?
21.
Okay, that hits. You have grappled the Kuthmaren, yes. So you've tied him up with a webbing, and you're holding him there. Spider-Man. Okay. You're tying him up. Spider-Man is also going to web grapple. And we're going to try a thing next move. Okay, let me take. Okay. He's going to fire. I don't know about this. No, that's a bad idea. Fuck that. Spider-Man goes over to one of the Kuthmaren and picks him up. I have an absurd strength. My strength is 49. I just pick one of them up and I throw him off the ledge.
Good night, Andy. Sleep well.
Yeah. Spider-Man walks over one of the Kuthmaren. It's like, yeah, I'm pretty sure this thing's already dead, and I'm doing it a favor. He just goes and picks up one of the ones that you already previously webbed up, and just throws it over the ledge, and it falls to its death. So Spider-Man just tossed one off the cliff. Lorala needs to make a will save to snap out of this. Natural one. She's crying. She's going moaning over to go, I'm sorry, my sisters. I'm so sorry. And the Kuthmaren. Okay, there's two left. The first one is going to spit acid at his own webbing and try to free himself. Oh, well, actually, like, 1d6 would be... You do like 1d6 automatically, I think. Yeah, 1d6. Deals 2 damage. He spits a gob. And he's free. Okay. So, one of the ones that you webbed up is no longer... he's melted all the webbing on him. The one that you've grappled is just going to spit acid right in your face.
Of course.
All right. And let's see. What's your AC? Ooh, 26. Okay. Acid in your face.
Yeah, I'm just going to...
Miss! It whizzes okay, past no. your head. You're fine. Okay, it is your go.
Good. I'm going to just toss it over. Because okay. At this point, I can't be bothered.
All right, so here's the thing. You've already grappled him with the webbing, so in true Spider-Man fashion, you basically just kind of lift him up, swing, and just toss. And, and splat. So, all right, there's one left, and Spider-Man is... that one already freed itself, though. That's the problem. And it's not really smart for him to touch this thing, so Spider-Man's going to web that one up, too. So, yeah, Spider-Man's just going to web this one up again. And he crits, and it's tied up. And Lorala's going to try to snap out of her panic. Nope, natural one. She's crying.
Still not out of here. Jesus.
Yay for feminism! So, let's see.
Awesome again.
Okay, so the Spider-Man webbed up the last Kuthmaren, and the acid started immediately melting it, and it spit more acid on it, but it's still tied up. It's still that the webbing's got one more hit point. It's your go.
I'll just toss it.
Are you sure you want to toss him, or are you sure you want to, like, football kick him off the ledge?
Let's punt him off the ledge.
You punt him off the ledge, Battletoad style. And in your mind, like, you hear Flash Thompson go, "Oh, and the quarterback is toast." So, okay. You have successfully defeated the Kuth Marin. Unfortunately, however, you're now outside the archway, and you've actually moved out of the bounds of the forbidden spell that you were in. But Spider-Man's going to try to comfort Lorala and see if she snaps out of it. She finally calms down. And just composes herself. And looks like, "They're so horrible. They were my sisters. And I could not avenge them. Drama." Okay, Venom, what are you going to do? And I just noticed Jotaro.
Yeah.
Get up, you lazy fuck. You die when I say you can. You're the what? Are you going to attempt to walk
around with this?
She's composed herself again. She's not crying anymore. She's just, like, she's kind of relenting that she wasn't very good in that fight. It's okay. They're scary as shit, man. You did blast one of them.
Gives me idea for creating flutter budgets. Chaotic neutral as a cleric, but not a vampire.
Okay. Why don't you call him just Jeff? Jeff, the man who is like flutter budgets, but not him.
Because people don't know what to expect with flutter budgets.
I know what to expect with flutter budgets.
To expect things.
I expect everything with flutter budgets. I expect everything's perfectly fine. He can't possibly fuck up this game right now. And it's like, but like, okay, let's see how he actually does it. And sure enough, session one fucked up.
Trust me, when Nathan gets in here, trust me, things are gonna get really weird.
That's true. You did eat a cyborg ninja's corpse for reasons I don't quite understand.
I did.
Yeah.
That I did.
Okay. So what are you gonna do?
Shit, sorry. I was looking at the Hangout Lounge again. God damn it.
Ugh. That's awesome.
Something. Hang on. I need to figure out what I'm gonna do.
Venom, your powers can't are nothing compared to my stand.
Tell me, Gideon. Have you ever run a game of Dungeons and Dragons?
I have not. Never.
What is your favorite class?
Be honest? Like I said, I've not played a single game of Dungeons and Dragons before I met Ed. So
yeah, he's brand new.
Have you played role-playing games before?
Brand new.
Like on computers? Like video games?
Okay, yeah.
Okay. How do you usually play through those?
Probably mage.
Okay.
So you're not exactly a mage now, but you do have the power of Black Tentacle.
No, I just needed to assign his roles.
Yeah. Okay. What
am I doing? Can I do? Where am I right now? Oh, wait, no, I'm outside the thing.
Yes. Which means you have to go back in the thing.
I'm gonna force my way back in.
You force your way back in the thing. Do a will save.
That's plus 8.
Total?
Oh, 19 plus 8, that's what?
27?
Yeah.
Again, you feel an evil presence is trying to kick you out, but you're like, oh, you, I'm Venom. I am the lethal protector, motherfucker, and I will kill Spider-Man. I will befriend Spider. Sometimes I want to kill you, Peter, because it's like, you know, and Spider-Man just kind of like looking at you with squinted eyes, like, okay, you have successfully entered. You're okay. Spider-Man looks at you from beyond the entryway, and it's like, well, third time's a charm. And he's going to try one more time. And he's bitch slapped out again.
Of course.
Okay, yeah, you know, Eddie, I'll stay here, and, yeah, just call if you need me. I'll web things from outside. I can't, yeah, now, my face hurts. My face hurts a lot. And so do my ribs. Oh, God. Spider-Man takes 8 damage and is shunted out once again. He is
Mr.
at 30.
Stark. I don't feel so well.
Mr. Stark. Mr. Stark, I don't feel so well. Have you seen that movie?
No, I have not.
You need to see that movie.
No, I don't need to. You just want me to.
Little column A, little column B.
I'm considering watching the new Hellboy movie, though.
I want to see that too, actually.
Because I kind of grew up with Hellboy.
Hellboy's awesome.
Like, the movies. Like, I kind of grew up with them.
Yeah, Hellboy's awesome. You should read the comics, too. The comics are good. But it's good. All right, Lorala tries also one more time and gets bitch slapped back and for her trouble. And like,
so
yeah,
I'm really the only person that's able to get in here.
You are the only person that can be able to get in there. We don't have any spellcasters, so we can't dispel this thing. And we wouldn't know.
It's like somebody needed a wizard.
God damn it, yes.
Would you like Quarter Budgets to come in and solve this one problem?
I don't care. You're welcome to play as Flutterbudgets if you wish. I don't. I'm the dungeon master, sort of, kind of, right now. So you're welcome to come in and dispel magic. You have to be level 16 though.
No, so, Flutterbudgets just swoops on down like, oh, okay, this is happening in another plane.
No, you need to be level 16.
Fearful mortal, what ails you today? You're passing this one magical barrier.
Okay, I'll tell you what. Dueling.
That would be what would happen.
Okay, roll a d100, and I will roll a d100. If you win, I'll let it happen.
If I win, Genji gets to decide the one problem that Flutterbudgets comes in out of nowhere and just solves.
And if I win, terrible irritable bowel syndrome.
E.
What'd you get?
E.
I'm about to roll.
Okay.
I have a 65.
I have a 77. No.
Damn.
Meanwhile, back on Earth, you are planning strategy with Nines Rodriguez and Ash. You've learned that most of the Deadites have basically made a stronghold somewhere in Texas. And you suspect that the Dark Ones are actually there and have their cop... They're basically kind of gathering their power there and are basically kind of creating a portal to hell. And that's what needs to be done. And you're like, okay, well, we should send a team to mobilize and do something about it. And then a woman right next to you suddenly falls very, very silent. And then her head spins around 360 degrees and says, I'll swallow your soul. And you are now, the camp is now being overrun by Deadites.
What the fuck is happening now? What?
We just jumped campaigns for a minute. So, yeah.
Everybody's cast a wish. I wish all the Deadites were dead.
Roll D100.
Damn it, I just put that away.
Ninety-nine. All the deadites that a deadite like flies over to you to rip your face up. I'll eat your face, you little flutter faggot. And it suddenly catches fire and explodes. And you're like, yeah, and you just look up at him and like swallow this. And then Ash looks over you. Hey, that's my line, you little shit. You then bust out a pair of sunglasses.
That campaign.
Yeah. You then bust out a pair of sunglasses, just put on your face, and it's like flutter budgets. And then somewhere AC/DC starts playing.
No. The ending themes of Friends starts to play.
Okay, I'll tell you what. Seinfeld. No, it starts off as AC/DC, and then Ash gets mad at you, and he changes the channel to Friends.
I approve of this conclusion to Flutter Budget's current campaign.
Okay. All right.
All right,
midget. Come on, get your spell books. Let's saddle up. We got a portal to hell to close up, and you start getting ready. And the vampires start.
Well,
getting
all the ready. Deadites are dead, so why would the portal still be around?
No. All the deadites that were attacking the camp were dead. You did not specify.
I said all the deadites.
No, you said all. You said all the deadites. You didn't say all the deadites on the planet. This is again. Wish spells is how the DM fucks with you. You were not clear. So as a result, not all the deadites are dead. You just killed all the ones that are here. And you would have gotten the chance maybe to cast another wish spell and take care of that, but unfortunately we have to cut back the city of Spider Queen. So meanwhile, yes. Venom,
wasn't he supposed to get like diarrhea or something?
Yes, and then you got, and then all of a sudden you let out a fart and your stomach doesn't feel too good. You need to run to the bathroom.
There you go.
To the latrine. There you go. All right.
What?
You did get a chance to be both badass and ridiculous in your own dimension.
Balance is restored.
Balance is restored to the Force. There you go. So,
the Star Wars movies can be good again.
Yes. Like, you know, you can...
You guys see the new Rise of Skywalker trailer?
Is that a fan movie?
Oh.
Is that the new movie coming out?
Yes.
Not going to see it.
Why?
Because Star Wars sucks now. And I don't think JJ has any chance of fixing it.
Watch the trailer. Just watch it and tell me.
No, I'm Star Wars is dead to me. I'm not. I will not be seeing. I will not be seeing the new Star Episode 9. I will sit on the sidelines and throw fruit. That's what I will do.
If it turns out to be good,
If it turns out to be good, I might check it out. But the problem is, Rian Johnson did so much damage with the last movie. I have no faith. And Kathleen Kennedy's still in charge for another 3 years. So no.
Palpatine's in it.
That's great. I don't want to see them ruin him either, like they've already done with Han Solo and Luke Skywalker. And, or for that matter, Lando. If Mr. 7 out of 10 can pull this off, bravo. Bravo. I'm still upset about him accusing me of being sexist for not liking The Last Jedi, which basically was not even his crappy project. And I don't know how you could possibly fix what Ryan fucked up in the previous installment. So it's
Okay.
I will sit on the sidelines and throw fruit. Like a mature person. But what are you gonna do?
Right now?
What?
What am I doing right now?
You are the only person that can go through the forbidden spell.
Okay. Just go into like 28 or something.
You want to go to
38?
S38. Okay. So there's a hallway, and then it leads to S38. Okay. So, yeah. All right. Let me take a look. A spiderweb ladder.
Might stop at three.
A spiderweb ladder, like the one in the entry, rises to a tunnel in the ceiling of this octagonal room.
What? Sorry, what?
Pay attention. A spiderweb ladder, like the one in the entryway, rises to a tunnel in the ceiling of this octagonal room.
Go up the ladder.
Okay, you need to make a reflex save. D20 plus 13.
Okay. Teen, you said?
Yeah, D20 plus 13, yes.
Okay. Yeah. Four.
Four total?
Four in,
Four plus 13.
4 plus 13, that's right.
Yeah. Not high enough. You put your hands on the webbing, and you are now stuck to it. You are entangled.
All right, I'm going to see if I can get out of it, because...
Okay.
You can get through.
All right. You will need to make a escape artist check.
In the background... DC. Okay. Escape artist plus four. Okay. Or so eight.
Eight in total.
Yeah.
No good. Still stuck. Every fail from here on will represent 15 minutes in which you are caught.
Oh, God damn it. Okay. Let's try again. Seven.
Total?
Which is 10.
Yep.
Oh, nope. 11.
Still stuck. 30 minutes.
Come on, damn it. Come on, break free. 15.
Total?
19.
19 is, you almost get free, but you're still stuck.
Really? Really? You're going to make me have to go in, really?
45 minutes.
Damn it. Morgan, fuck this. No, we're going to keep going.
Okay.
Three? No, damn it.
What'd you roll?
I'm trying to find something good. 14. Well, not high enough. You're gonna make me go in. You're gonna make me go straight into like.
I think you rolled a fourth time and you couldn't get out.
I hit 14 eventually.
Okay, 14's not the DC you need to make. If you're looking at, yeah, your the escape artist check, like, that's listed on your webbing is what it takes for other people to get out of your webbing. This is a different type of, this is a different check for this webbing. So, you rolled three times and failed three times, right?
Pretty much.
Okay, so after struggling for about 45 minutes, you hear some footsteps from behind you.
Crap.
Well, what on earth is that? You hear a voice say to you.
Oh, crap.
Some kind of spider kind. Another creature of Loth out to avenge its master. Amusing. What do you think its blood tastes like? I don't know. You try it first. I'm full. Okay. Well, let's have a bite. Roll initiative.
Wonderful. This is wonderful.
And you're all alone, too.
Yeah, good fun. Damn.
Grumble, grumble, grumble.
Help me here. Random number generator. Help me.
They can't see you anymore, so they can't.
Thank you, God.
What'd you roll?
18 plus 4.
What'd you roll? What'd you roll?
So that's 22.
What is this? Is this an initiative roll?
And I added 4.
Okay, that's your initiative roll.
Yes.
Okay.
Ha! Found what I was looking for.
Okay, so you rolled a 22. Okay. All right. I got they're in the back of the book, so I got to go look them up real quick.
Yeah. One
second. Page 138. Okay.
Are they going to stop at 3, by the way?
Would you like to stop at 3?
Yeah.
Okay. The
church and whatnot. We can pick this up after I come home.
Okay, that's fine. I'm fine with that. Alright. My initiative. Is a 17. And you had a 22?
Yes.
You go before them.
I'm still stuck to this ladder, though.
You are still stuck to the ladder, yes.
Doesn't mean the symbiote can't defend me, even though I'm still...
How many hands did you... Well, okay. Did you use both hands trying to get free?
I used one.
Okay, all right. So you are stuck to the webbing by one hand. So you can still defend yourself. You're just stuck.
She's good. Okay, so. Okay, they're trying to eat me. I'm a web bullet them.
Okay. You may fire when ready.
Do my roll saves. First one. That's 3 plus 4. 34 is the first one.
34 is the first one?
Mm-hmm.
It hits.
40 is the second one.
Hits.
31 plus 15, what's that?
31 plus 15?
It's
45. 46.
Yep.
Okay. All three of those hit. Are you going to use this all on one of them, or just...
How many are there?
There's two. When you turn around and look, you notice that they're drow, but they look oddly pale. Their eyes are bright red, and they have sharp fangs coming out of their teeth.
Oh, wonderful. Yeah. Vampires.
Yes, there is blood dripping from their mouths. You suspect vampire. Are you gonna how many? There's two of them, so are you gonna hit one or both? And is it gonna be 2-on-1 and 1-on the other one, or like 3-on just one of them?
I'll hit both.
Okay, so one of them's gonna take 2 and one of them's gonna take 1?
Yes.
Okay. All right, you deal 14 damage with your bullets, right? So that's 28 and a 14. Okay. And some quick math. Okay. All right, you startle the two vampires. You're like, you snarl and bah, bah, and start firing web bullets at them and pelt them in the side and the face and and like start knocking them back, and it's like, oh, not bad. That actually hurt. And they're very upset with you. They're very upset with you, and they think you're a very you are a very ruly dinner guest. And I just realized something. They may have been able to take a little bit more of that than, yeah, they're okay. All right. So the one that you hit with just the one bullet, just looks kind of minorly annoyed. It's like you kind of hit him in the chest, and he looks startled. He has this look of a man who's been hit with a fish, and he's actually going to go first in terms of attacking you. So he's going to approach, and he's going to approach with his hulking vampire fist and punch you in the face twice. And 13 plus 8. And what's your AC? 26. Okay. 13 plus 8. All right. Okay. The first one hits, and okay, he hits you twice. The other one, was a little more badly bruised, and he draws a rapier. It's like, ha ha, and he's going to stab you twice. First attack hits. And second attack is a 6 and a 10, 16. All right, so one punches you twice, the other one stabs you once. Okay, so the vampire that punches you, you take 2 die 6 plus 10 plus 2 energy drain. That's not good.
What? 2 die 6 plus 10?
Yes. All right, so you take 12 damage.
You'll do that for me. Never mind.
Hmm?
Never mind. You would do that for me.
Your character dies a terrible, terrible death. You take 2 negative levels. You are now effectively at level 14. So. His hands glow as he comes up to you and punches you in the face twice, and you feel as he like cracks your body, you feel like your life force being drained of both you and the symbiote. You are now effectively at level 14.
I regain this?
You'll have to make a fortitude save after combat to restore your negative levels, and hopefully you'll get it. You're a rogue. Davis, what's a rogue's hit dice again in 3.5?
It's either a d6 or a d8, and I'm leaning towards the 8.
Okay.
0.5 rogue. It's a d6.
It's a d6? Okay. So you lose an additional 22 hit points from that attack. So... You're now at 136. So you did not like that at all. And the stab actually doesn't feel that bad by comparison. It's you just take 1d6 plus 8. You take 11 damage from that. Okay. So, yeah. -170 minus 125. All right. -45. Yeah, you've taken 45 damage. So you're at 125 health, and 14 levels. What are you gonna do?
Um, Alright. This is annoying me. So we're gonna just entangle the one I hit.
The one that punched you? Okay. Okay, remember you can web entangle three times. So, you know, really if you do it twice, they will be entangled. And don't forget, you have a certain ability that's helpful. Regenerate. You heal. You have regeneration 6, so you're back up to 131.
Okay, so yeah, we'll have entangle the guy that punched me twice.
Okay.
I'm gonna do
your roll.
Once. Just whatever number I say, just add it to what's the.
No, you need to learn how to do this yourself. You need to actually like learn how to read your own character sheet and add these things up yourself, sir. So you need to be able to do.
Oh, that's. Seven. Let's see.
But I am looking at what do you roll?
Okay, I rolled a 17.
So that hits.
And then you will A. That's 29 for the third one.
For the second one?
Third one, because the first one I rolled a 3.
Oh. Okay.
I rolled a 3, a 17, and a 5.
Okay. You hit with the first two. They are entangled. They cannot be any more entangled.
Okay.
So you've webbed up and entangled the vampires. They are going to. The first one that punched you, he is going to try to Brock Lesnar his way out of this and try to rip out of it. With a break DC, I need a plus 5. And 22, not quite. The other one is going to try to escape artist it. And he has a plus 4. 22, not quite. They're good and stuck. As are you. So, it's a good old-fashioned Mexican standoff.
Alright.
So what are you gonna do?
I put up some negative levels, so I'm a fortitude save right now.
You're gonna try to do your fortitude save for that right now.
I mean, they can't move.
Oh, I almost forgot. They can do something.
That
Oh, yeah, they can do something else. Oh, I'm dumb. Hang on. Davis.
Yes.
I'm dumb.
I already knew.
I keep on bitching and moaning about, like, Dungeons & Dragons vampires. And yet I forget about the advantages of Dungeons & Dragons vampires.
Fuck, they can turn into gas. Fuck. I forgot about that.
They can. They can.
Actually, if their hit points drop to 0, they do turn into a fart cloud and float back to their coffin immediately. Like, that is the immediate direction they start going.
They can turn into gas at will, right?
They can do that too. But if you were to reduce them to 0 hit points without properly disposing of them, they turn into gas immediately and float to their coffin.
Into gas right now after I entangled them.
They would have done it like before if I hadn't been stupid. And all right.
Problem.
Okay, Davis. Level drain, 3.5. Like fortitude save. What do you have to do for it?
I want to say it's constitution based.
Yeah.
3.5.
Like energy drain is thing what it's under. Yeah. No saving to avoid gaining the negative list, but 24 hours after gaining them, the subject must make a fortitude saving throw, DC equals energy drain, spell, plus save DC for negative level. If they save succeeds, the negative level is removed. If it fails, the negative level also goes away, but one of the subject's character's level is permanently drained. Yeah, so you cannot do that now. You have to wait a day. So, there you go. Are you there, sir? Hello.
Hello.
Okay. Hello, sir. Hello. Did you hear me? Hello. God damn it. Hello. Ah.
Again.
Okay, here we go. All right. So you have to wait. Can you hear me?
I can hear you. I'm about to read energy.
Yeah, you cannot make the save until 24 hours has passed.
Oh. That's,
so and okay. then you make the save for it. So
energy drain under 3.5. When the vampire reaches 7th.
God damn it.
5 temporary hit points. You can use it.
God damn it. Round. You keep going robot on me.
Level the vampire's slam attack or other natural attack. This does.
Hello.
You keep roboing out on me, man. Okay.
Does that help?
That does, yes. Thank you, sir. Yeah, just like the stupid fucking Discord being a pain in the ass.
So ultimately, there's no save for having having an energy drain. It's just a permanent negative level, and you have to earn that level back.
If he doesn't make his fortitude save, if he makes his fortitude save after a day, he can get those levels back.
If that's how you want to rule it.
Yeah, that's how. Like I was looking over energy drain, specifically, and that's what it said. And I was looking right at it, but I thought that might have been the reason why I was having trouble, so that's why I clicked it off.
3.5 vampire.
Ugh, wonderful.
Okay. But yeah, anyway, you can't do your fortitude save right now. So what are you gonna do?
So I'm stuck to this ladder.
Stuck to the ladder.
And it's been entangled by me.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't broken free yet.
Nope.
Web bullet.
Okay, you web bullet. Fire away.
13 plus... What was it again? Plus... 31. Plus 31, that's 44. And 10 plus 26 is...
What was the first one?
The first one was 13 plus 31, which is 44.
Hits.
And the second one is 15 plus 26, which is 41.
That hits as well.
And I could use the third one. You know what? Yeah, I'll use the third one.
Okay.
3 plus... Anymore. It's 41. Yeah.
41?
Because I got a natural 20.
Natural 20, you crit.
Yeah. And then okay. I added to my thing.
All right.
Which made it 41.
So you hit both of them. Like, are you hitting both of them or just one of them?
Punched me all three times because it's kind of annoying.
You're going to hit just one of them all three times?
Yeah, because he caused my level drain, and I'm annoyed at that.
Okay, so you crit. You deal 14 damage with a bullet, so that's 28. Another 14, that would be 42. And the last one would be 66, I want to say. 39. No, 54. Yeah, 54. Wait. 56. It was 56. Okay, you deal. Ooh, good job. All right. So, you're like rah, and you just like start shooting bullets, web bullets, right at the lead vampire. You just trounce him over and over again. I just remember something. Let's see. Okay, how much does he take? It's 56. He actually takes 41. So, all right, you lay into him. You lay into him with those three bullets. Just bam, bam, bang. Just, like, it pounds into his chest and, like, bruises him, smacks him in the face. Looks like it breaks his jaw. And he looks pretty worn down. But he's still standing. Okay, his move and his buddy's move. His jaw starts to heal. And they both turn to gas. And the webbing just falls to the ground, and they move slightly, and they reform, and they are no longer entangled. Your move.
We're web bullets. We're web bullying them.
You're web bullying them. By the way, remember, you also heal 6 each round, so...
So what am I? What was my? I know I got hit.
On,
I don't
remember. Hold on. Stop. Remember, you heal 6 hit points each round. Okay. I shouldn't. Now, other dungeon masters aren't going to remind you of this. They'll just let you die. So.
Okay. So good dungeon masters will try to keep everyone on top of their abilities.
Yes.
Shitty DMs, and if you go to the Adventure League stuff at, like, game shops and stuff that they do for D&D, they're not gonna help you at all. They're going to assume you know everything that is happening at the table immediately.
Right.
So
what I'm trying to say is I've been keeping track of your hit points. I shouldn't be doing that. So it's like, because yeah, I should be ignoring the fact that you have a healing factor and just let you die. But I am as generous as I am kind.
Well, he can do that, but he's a good friend.
Indeed. Doing my best to be one.
He's also helping you keep track of things, especially since you're playing such a high-level character for some of your first games.
Yeah.
You're going to need all the help you can get. Don't be ashamed to ask for help or to say, I'm kind of confused or I'm lost on something. Can you explain it to me? This is literally your first opening experience of Dungeons & Dragons, and you're going into the wackiest, most overpowered shit you've probably ever imagined happening at a table. And personally, I don't think that's the right way to introduce players to Dungeons & Dragons. That is personally going towards Eddie with that comment. But
you must remember, sir, I am insane.
You're insane, and that's how you scare people away from the game. By making it immediately overly complex, instead of starting people off at, like, between levels 1 and 3. And having them play the game and get a feel for how things work.
Well, we did. The problem was we were supposed to be at actually, like, level 5 or 6. We were supposed to be at level 5, actually.
Well, then don't run them through City of the Spider Queen. Give him another introductory...
It's the easiest thing I could fucking run, sir. It was the easiest thing I know. So
you can't come up with something?
No. It was, like, on the spur of the moment, and I had all my books, and like, I did that. No, I just... Yeah, I other than that, I gotta, like...
You legitimately should have pulled a a page out of Nick's book.
And what is a page? What is a page out of Nick's book?
Nick's book of DMing is literally come up with something.
I normally would, especially if we're doing free flow, but since this is Dungeons and Dragons and requires a lot of rules, I feel that order must be maintained.
Which also means that you can run a completely made-up campaign off the top of your head and still make it work.
Yes, but then I wouldn't be able to use Dungeons & Dragons, which is what they wanted to do, so that's what I did.
No, you would have still been able to use Dungeons & Dragons. You would have been in the same system, you just would have been in a different campaign.
Stop backseat DMing.
Stop being a good DM?
You're not DMing right now. I'm DMing. You're backseat DMing. So, excuse me, Dad, but I'm in charge of the family vacation this year. Don't worry, I'll get you some more Jell-O at the home.
Genji, you need help with something and you're not sure what to do or what you can do, just let me know. I'll do my best to help you and point you in the right direction as to what would be your best option based off of what you can do. And that way, hopefully, you won't feel so overwhelmed with it.
Thanks for that. And if you I just sat here in silence.
If you want to start a game at some point,
who put porn here?
If you need to understand, let me know. I'll try to
make sure that.
Oh shit.
And he's gone. Sorry about that. And he's back.
No, there's like four Archangel put like porn, and well, it's not really. It's mannequins fucking, but still, I.
What?
When she says she likes rough sex, it's like okay, I can't put that on YouTube. So.
No. You had sense of that.
Well, I don't. You never know. Fuckers will false flag you for anything.
Yeah, I just sat through that, just silence.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know where that...
Things happen.
Daddy hit mommy.
It was weird to listen to, I don't know why.
We had a spat.
Time.
That was very gay. That was very. We just had just like we had like a married couple squabble.
It was weird.
You're not teaching him D&D right, and it's like he's ready. He's ready now for play the venom. He's ready to play the crazy.
I mean, unless this is what
bam, boom, straight to the moon, flood of budgets.
Unless this is what you walk in expecting, Genji. I mean. By all means.
I'm trying to raise him to do all the wrong things. So, It's like, look, it's perfectly innocent. It's just like in Animal Farm when the lead pig took a bunch of dogs and raised them to be ruthless attack dogs in order to take over the farm. It's perfectly innocent. There's nothing totally, you know. I mean, just it's perfectly innocent, Davis. Perfectly
Why
innocent.
Are you bringing Animal Farm into this?
Don't know.
That's a book I actually remember reading in school. Okay.
Oh my god! I made a reference and you got it.
That's like, if I remember correctly,
there's a full moon out.
That's the book describing how communism can be very bad.
Yes. Yes, it is.
Yes, I remember that book.
Yeah, it's a good book. It's a little depressing, but yes.
I don't remember all the little tidbits about it.
Yeah.
But if you say Animal Farm, I got the general idea of what you're talking about.
Yes.
God.
Anyway. But no, one would normally start playing an elf or a dwarf. It's just I hate elves and dwarves. I want to cut the beards of the dwarves and box the ears of the elves and have them be destroyed by angry machines with laser beam eyes because metal. Metal, Davis.
Okay, so
metal and comic books.
Note to self: Eddie is not a newbie-friendly DM.
You will enable my dysfunction. You will enable my pathology.
I'm not enabling anything.
You will. You will appease the voices in my head.
I will. The voices
with sacrifices of beer. What about the voices with sacrifices of beer and cocaine.
What?
Beer and cocaine.
I could get you on the beer, but the cocaine is a completely different story.
I want nose candy, damn it.
I can get you what's that powdered candy stuff that that Pop Rocks. I can get you Pop Rocks.
It's going straight up my nose. Okay, where were we? So Venom.
I can mail that shit from Amazon to you, man.
Okay, so Venom. There's two vampires that are now unentangled. What are you gonna do?
Okay, I can't. Ugh.
You did heal. You did heal a little bit.
Okay, you know, how close is the vampire that punched me?
He's within 5 feet.
Is he close enough that I can bite him?
Yes, you can.
Bite him.
Okay, you lunge forward and bite his face.
Yeah, that's a plus 53. Give me one.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Why did I give you that?
14.
What is wrong with me? Davis, I'm sorry, you're right. I think you hit, but roll.
67.
What was I right about?
One of his attacks is plus 53.
67.
57.
I rolled a 14.
Okay. You hit. He takes 9 damage.
Good. That felt good.
Okay. He does not look too good. You bite a big chunk out of his neck, and he clutches his neck and starts snarling at you. Let's see. Okay. The wound starts healing.
Hit him again.
Well, the problem is your bite attack is your off attack. So what you can do is you can just make an unarmed strike. What I'll let you do is, like, instead of you letting you do the bite, if you make an unarmed strike, you can do your full unarmed strike bonus. Which, since you're Venom, I've been kind of thinking about this. I'll include tentacles if you want to get creative. They can be punches, kicks, tentacles, like whatever you want them to be. But it's all going to be your unarmed strike.
Oh my god, Eddie!
What?
I can send you Pop Rocks for less than $10.
Okay. All right. I will pay the $10 if you ground them up so they're snortable.
Wait. Is this actually happening?
I can get them to you. In the original package. You can do everything else yourself.
Okay. Well, I'm not paying the shipping in that case.
No. I wouldn't pay for shipping to begin with.
Okay. All right. Well, first things first.
I need your address.
I'm not gonna give you that on the stream.
Type it, then DM it to me.
They can see my display right now.
Why are you okay?
Later.
Text it to me.
My phone's broken. I will happily do this. We will do it later. You can make 3 unarmed attacks.
Alex. Hey, let's just do that. Okay.
You streaming right now?
I'm giving.
Or are you just recording?
I'm recording, but I'm using the display so that people can see something.
Okay. I thought that's what I thought you were doing was recording.
Yes, that's
not
why
streaming.
I'm concerned about. That's why I'm concerned about mannequin fucking.
No, I completely understand that. But you said streaming, and I was like, wait a minute. No wonder you're cutting in and out left and right.
If only, yeah, I were, because then I would have an excuse. You may make 3 unarmed attacks with your bite being... Your bite was your offhand. You just did it first. So you may make... go to your unarmed strike.
56, 51, 46.
Yes, you may make 3 attacks.
Okay.
Do describe what you're doing, though, like punching, kicking, tentacle slapping, Okay. Turn your hands into blades or something like that, whatever you want.
I'm going to turn my free hand into a blade, because I remember I'm still technically strapped to this goddamn ladder.
Okay. You are strapped to this goddamn ladder. You are still entangled.
I'm going to turn one hand into a blade.
You're getting demonetized, like, immediately.
Yeah, I know.
Do you even get paid for this?
Go. No. Neither of us are monetized on YouTube.
That's true.
It sucks anyway.
I figured I wouldn't bother.
On YouTube. I'm officially able to do that now.
Okay, so make your attacks.
Okay, so we're going to slice the vampire that punched me.
Okay.
With this blade arm.
Okay.
We're gonna kick. Wait. He's the only one that's close to me. Kick him.
Okay.
Then we're gonna just punch him in the face.
That's good. Which is a good idea, because you've noticed that his neck has healed up incredibly fast.
Give me a minute. We're going to just go through rolling.
Okay.
20. That's a crit.
Okay.
Plus 56. That's...
Hold on. You have cleave, right?
What?
You have cleave, right?
No. These are the unarmed strikes.
Yeah, I know. You have cleave.
I do?
You can cleave with an unarmed strike. Trust me. Roll your damage for that crit you just rolled.
Okay.
Which would be...
So...
2 die 3 plus 60.
Okay. Wait, what do I change the max to? Do I have to change it at all, or
min to 2 and max to 6?
Okay. 4.
Okay. 64 damage. All right. You come in with the blade and actually lop his head off. He looks astounded as his head falls to the ground and his body disintegrates into mist and shoots off in another direction. And while you're in mid motion, you see that you can launch yourself further and use that same attack at a plus 56 and hit the other vampire next to you.
That I will do that.
Okay.
Oh, same thing. And well, we've got to go to a one die 20, right?
Yes.
Back to a 2 die 6?
If you hit, yes.
Okay, give me a minute. Got 10. And then... So I'm pretty certain that hit.
66 does hit, yes.
Okay, so... And then, now that it's hit, I've got to cleave. So that's a 2.
Well, no, you cleave if you drop him.
I drop him, okay.
Yeah, I gave that to you because he was low on health. He had like 16 health left.
Okay.
And I knew it's like, all right, he just crit and he has plus 30 to his damage. So it's like, all right, you're gonna do 60 damage. You're gonna drop him. So
okay. Oh, I got 10.
10 damage?
Do it. Well, hang on.
There's only one more left in the room. Just wail on him with every attack you've got.
Okay.
And we'll add it up later.
Ten, three.
Well, 10 plus 56 is a 66. That hits.
Yeah.
3 plus 51 equals 54. That hits. And last one?
46. 1 plus 46, that's 47.
Oh, you rolled a 1?
Yeah.
One's a crit fail, so we'll hold off on that one. Okay, do your damage. Do your damage for the first two.
Okay, so that's...
1 die 3 plus 60. So 2 die 3 plus 60. So it would be 2 minimum, 6 maximum.
We have... First one.
Okay.
Wait, you say
and for the second one, we've got 6.
Okay.
We got a crit.
No, okay. It's your unarmed attack is 1 die 3 plus 30. So, yeah, basically, your minimum, you roll them together, so you'd only roll it once. So if you... Yeah, okay, you did what I said, actually. Okay, just roll it.
Okay, roll it again?
Yeah, well, roll the... Yeah, your minimum's 2 and your max is 6. Roll that.
Yeah.
I made it confusing.
So I got the result.
Sorry, what is it?
Result is 4.
4? Okay, so 4 plus 60 is 64. Minus 15 is... Hang on. 9. Hang on. I think... Oh, this is easy math, and I'm having trouble with it. I'm dumb. Okay. Alright, so you slash him twice and just blood erupts out of his body and he looks worse for wear. But then you come one last time and he actually catches your blade ham in his arm and he holds you there and he basically you're not able to he stops your last attack basically. But all he's gonna do is just grab you. That's all he's gonna do. All right, he heals and what is he gonna do? So we get to bite people. Maybe I should have a snack. He grabs your hand and lunges inward and is going to grapple you and bite you.
Dodge that.
So you need to roll a strength check.
Oh. 62.
You roll a 62. All right, he tries to wrestle you. Okay, roll your modifier, which is a 26.
Back. Six is 34, I believe.
34. Okay. He tries to grapple you and tries to sink his fangs in his neck, but you are strong enough to hold him back with one hand. And even when he starts moving in a little bit closer, your tentacles are starting like grappling him and starting pushing him back. So you are able to push him off you. It is your move.
Okay. A tentacle.
Okay. That would be an unarmed strike. So, go ahead and attack.
Okay, we've got 14.
Total?
14 plus the 56.
70. That hits.
Yes, we could... I mean, he's holding my other hand. He's holding my,
No, you pushed him off. He's...
Oh, yeah, you're right. Okay, yeah, I did. Let's try biting him again. That'd be fine.
Well, roll your damage for the tentacle real quick.
Okay.
1 die 3. Plus 30.
Okay.
Four.
it's 34.
34? Okay. Ugh. All right. You slap him with a tentacle. And when you slap him with such force that it, like, strikes his chest and shatters his body, crumpling his back in two. He falls slumping to the floor and then turns into mist and flies off in the same direction the other vampire went off in.
Nice.
And you are still stuck to a web ladder.
All right. I'm going to... Now that they're gone, get myself off this ladder.
All right.
Because it's annoying.
All right, get yourself off the web ladder.
Oh. That's a 1 die 20 again, right?
Yeah, plus your escape artist check.
And give me a minute. Let me look at that. It's 4. So... We got 9. 13.
What'd you get?
Got 13 because I rolled a 9.
You are still stuck. You're stuck for another 15 minutes.
I will eventually get something high enough to make this work.
Yes.
Alright. 13 plus 4, that's 17.
Another 15 minutes. You're stuck for 30 minutes.
Alright. 6. Damn it. It's 10. Still 2.
45 minutes.
12. No.
You make a strength check. You've been at this for like 45 minutes.
26.
26 for a strength check? Alright, did you make a strength check?
40.
Okay. After 45, after a good hour of doing this, you can finally get frustrated, and you just, with all your might, you just pull back and just rip the ladder open. And, like, extricate yourself from it.
God, that was annoying. Okay.
Hey, Davis, how fast do vampires regenerate?
Want to say, like, fast healing 5 or something like that?
Yeah.
Are you saying, like, how fast they go from being a zero hit points to no longer being a fart cloud?
Right.
As soon as Finn, they...
You going robo on me.
Full health.
Hello?
Hey, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Oh.
Okay, so they are, when they hit 0 hit points, they turn into a fart cloud and start floating back to their coffin.
Yeah.
They reach their coffin, they are no longer a fart cloud, and they are sleeping until they regain their full HP.
Okay.
There we go.
I'm not sure on the exact time frame, but I do believe that is the process.
And it's like fast healing 5 every 6 seconds, so, okay. Alright, I know what to do with them. Alright, you are free of the webbing. What are you going to do?
Actually got to go to sleep now. 3:12.
Yeah.
Church in the morning and shit.
You will not sleep. You will play. Nine. Okay. All right. So you're in S8, which we will call the realm of the fucking web ladder. And yes. Yeah, that's where you're. Oh. I feel stupid. So there's a bunch. All of these are S8. Before you go, which one, did you go to the left? Or did you go to the right?
Hang on. I gotta turn it and look at it from my.
Yeah, because if you notice that it's a big octagon, and all those little points of the octagon are actually S8s. So the nearest one you would have been able to go to would have either been the one to your left,
I went to the left one.
You went to the right. Okay, so you're actually further down on the page, like right next to S40. So that's where you're at. So that's where we'll come back to you.
You want tomorrow?
You want to play tomorrow? Okay, cool. Yeah. What time do you get back from church?
2-ish. If my grandmother doesn't keep me there until like 4.
Okay, I'll try to be on at 2:00. I need to go fix my phone. So people can contact me. So, but okay. Yeah, your character died last time.
Yes.
You did not die this time.
Wait, Genji.
Yes.
You have church on Saturday?
Seventh-day Adventist.
Okay. Do that.
Most people are confused as to why we do that. It's because we're Seventh-day Adventists. I believe that Saturday was the day that God rested, not Sunday. What day do we celebrate God? Which makes absolutely no sense, because we pretty much all celebrate God anyway.
Yeah,
well,
it doesn't matter.
Saturday is the day that God took to rest, but Sunday was the day he made holy, which would be the day to worship him fully. So Saturday would be, yes, a day of rest, but Sunday would be the day of worship.
People in our religion, they say that God made the seventh day, rested on the seventh day, and hallowed it, but I think they're talking about the same day. And he also hallowed that day, not the next day. That's what.
Literally, just need to look at Genesis chapter 1 and 2 for that.
See, I was gonna title this chapter like Spider-Man Venom separation anxiety as a reference to the video game and storylines of the comics from back in the day, but I'm thinking really this should just be called "That's Staying In." That's it. Oh, you're freaking like your computer screws up. Yeah, that's staying in. Oh, porn, mannequin porn on your desktop. That's staying in.
Yes.
Oxenius and I have a spat, a lover's quarrel. That's staying in.
Well, I just
my computer. That's staying in.
Oh yeah. Okay. So yeah, he blessed. He rested on the seventh day and made it holy. He created. He gave humans everything on the sixth day.
And most importantly, religious debate. That's staying in.
Religious debates. Because that's what I want to hear on a YouTube video.
Yeah.
Because that's not going to get you demonetized at all.
The mannequin picture is already going to do it. So, I mean, all right. I'm hopefully this thing will be all right. I think the trick is just like, because I've had trouble like when ending these things that if like it'll just won't stop for like some of these longer streams. But whatever the case, I had a good time. I hope you did too.
And I did.
I'm amazed that I was able to do so, like half asleep. And Davis, you are a joy and a pleasure and a doddle, at always. I don't know what that means. It's English. It's an English thing.
Words. It's words. So,
yes. Yes. Yeah. Okay.
It's coming to my room yet.
Hope you enjoyed the game, folks. This is the Dread Pirate saying, "None of you can ever defeat my stand." Have a good night.